Broadcasting live from the Gruber Law Office's One Call That's All studio at the Avenue in downtown Milwaukee. This is Kyle Bruston Nortman, KBN, on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
I'm already annoyed by Kyle Wallace, and that wasn't even the first thing that we talked about on the air. So I'm trying to bring the show in, and I'm excited to do something, but you're like, this is the definition that I gave him. He's the 7-year-old who loves the Green Bay Packers and is convinced they're going to win every game, and when they lose, he doesn't understand why. You are a child.
I think this is a you issue. Brad didn't have an issue. Chris didn't have an issue.
Because Brad isn't in my seat. If he was in my seat and wanted to start the show, he'd be like, shut up,
and
too.
And I can't hear you.
Yeah.
Oh, so you guys got issues, huh?
No, just shut up. That's Kyle Wallace, already annoying me. Brad Nortman is our longtime NFL punter, who I respect much more on this show. Chris Larson running the show. I'm Ben Brust. I want to have some fun today. 800-990-3776. Obviously, I want to have fun every day. But let's get political without getting political. It is going to be the ESPN Wisconsin Talent presidential election. We have taken ourselves out of it. Chris Larson, Ben Brust, Brad Nortman, and Kyle Wallace. We will not be eligible today to be paired as a president and vice president of ESPN Wisconsin. I very much look forward to this because there are some people that I very much would pick and some talent that I wouldn't want near a ballot if people were voting on, which in our case will be on Twitter at KBN ESPN. You can get us on YouTube at ESPN Madison and at ESPN Milwaukee. 800-990-3776 if you want to get involved. As again, we are Kyle Bruston Nortman across ESPN Wisconsin. Kyle, say something worth saying right now.
KBN Nation, y'all better keep me from Latrell Sprewell and Ben at some point during this show.
I would love for you to.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, that's right. Sit down. You ain't doing anything. You're smiling. You're not going to do anything while we're smiling.
I would love to see Kyle Wallace, Latrell Sprewell, somebody. That would be
for those who don't know what a Latrell Sprewell is, please let the audience know.
He choked his coach, PJ Carlissimo. He choked his coach.
I think he
choked him. Yeah, yeah, he choked him. And shout out to Latrell Sprewell.
So you're going to Draymond Green me?
No. I don't know. I'm not going to.
He choked Rudy Gobert.
No. Oh, I thought you were about punching Jordan Poole.
Well, that?
I'm not going to punch you. I wouldn't do that.
Is choking that much better?
I feel like it's not. It's still aggressive. Michael Jordan punched Steve Kerr. But that one gets applauded for some reason.
Well, if that were the case, he's Steve Kerr, I'm Michael Jordan, I got to punch him.
That's true.
Brad Nortman is our longtime NFL punter. But what we're going to do now is we're going to bring in our executive producer at ESPN Wisconsin. Ashton Rotman has prepared 1, 2, 3, and 4. So pick the draft order for Brad, Chris, Kyle, and myself as we are going to draft our ESPN Wisconsin president and vice president. So, Chris, whenever you want to hit the presidential music, that will work here. You want me to pick first? Oh, what a privilege. Ben Brust in the ESPN Wisconsin presidential election. We'll be picking third.
That's a pretty good spot,
this will
actually
snake. And it is a good spot because yep. I'm not going to be stuck with the two worst on the way back.
First. That Whoa. Is quite the position to be in.
Oh,
I'm
wow.
at my pick of the litter for president.
Kyle Wallace selecting.
Fourth.
That means Chris Larson
nice.
Is selecting second. All right. The order of the... thank you, Ashton Rotman. You are excused. Brad Nortman picking first in the ESPN Wisconsin Talent presidential election.
Do we... Oh, yeah.
Chris Larson second, Ben Brust third, and Kyle Wallace fourth.
Would we like to inform the listeners who's all eligible to be on the president and vice president ballot?
I got you, Brad.
Thank you. I need a reminder too.
Jen Latta of Jen, Gabe, and Chewy, morning 7 to 9 on 94.5 ESPN, a prominent personality on ESPN's College Game Day. Gabe Neitzel, longtime Good Karma Brands ESPN Wisconsin talent, as Wisconsin as it gets. Mark Shimura, Packers Hall of Famer. Do I'm not going to insert my political thoughts on Mark Chmura right now. Steve the Homer True, and if you want to see Homer talk a little politics, follow him on Twitter. He's been going crazy on there right now. Mark Tauscher, Packers Hall of Famer, which you can hear 9 to noon across these very stations. Jason J. Wilde, longtime NFL reporter for the Green Bay Packers, Madison.com, Wilde and Tausch. You hear him everywhere on our station. Packers tackle, former tackle, Brian Bulaga. He joins Homer from 5 to 6. He joins us at 4:45 on Mondays. Jim Rutledge and Matt Hamilton of Rutledge and Hamilton. I almost kept them as one person, even though they are two, but we will separate them. John Anderson of ESPN, longtime ESPN SportsCenter host. Alex Stroff, host of Mr. Irrelevant, which you can hear on ESPN Madison's YouTube. Tori Lowe of 101.7 The Truth and Tori Lowe Tuesdays on Kyle Bruston-Ortman. And last but not least, but likely least and last, will be Jesse Nelson, the producer of Wilde and Tausch. Brad, with all of the candidates that I have now let the audience know, Ernie, real quick, 800-990-3776. Kyle, please go Sprewell on Ben. He deserves it.
I got you. I don't know who says it, but
Ernie in a barn near Elroy.
Well, I mean, I'm sure a lot of...
I never knew a barn guy and Kyle would get along so well.
That is exactly what the disdain for Ben Bruss really, it goes across all people, right? Everybody can feel the same thing. We may not be able to agree on everything, but when it comes to putting our hands around Ben Bruss' neck, I will be doing the America and KBN Nation a favor.
And I'm not going to lie, you know, I'm not going to be one of those bystanders that will, you know, jump in. I'm going to be one of the guys that just sits
enjoys
back, eating popcorn. I might record it.
About damn time.
Finally got what he is due. We now turn it over to Brad Nortman for his presidential selection with the first overall draft pick of the ESPN Wisconsin Presidentials.
I'm very excited to have the first pick overall. I am very scared to have the last pick overall. But for the very first pick overall, I'm going to go with none other than Mark Tauscher.
That is the
minus
2,000 favorite to go number one overall.
Certainly was. And I've already started to put my campaign together for Mr. Tauscher on why he is the rightful president of this country. Coming up next. Chris, you're next.
Chris Larson with the number two pick on the ESPN Wisconsin presidential election draft.
If I had the number one pick, that was going to be my choice. So Brad took who I wanted to become the president on the ESPN Wisconsin ticket. But the second choice I had is still out there, obviously, because I'm picking number two. I'm going with Steve the Homer.
Wow.
Go with the old theme.
Hey, it's the U.S. People love voting for old in this country.
I do love Homer.
That was great. Oh, man.
That went in my back pocket for whoever chose Homer.
Fitting in with the current old, current political climate.
Correct.
All right. Well, I can toss out Rutledge and Hamilton. That's easy. I'm going to toss out Chewy. That's easy. This comes down to two lead hosts on our ESPN Wisconsin stations. Jen Gabe and Chewy of 94.5 ESPN and Wilde and Tausch. But I'm going to go with one. Oh, man. I want to pick myself over these two.
Shocker.
That's why people want your, you know, hands around your neck, but...
I'm going to sound like a suck-up, but I'm not doing it because I'm a suck-up. Jen Latta of Jen, Gabe, and Chewy.
Oh, the Marquette grad.
Wow. Okay. Why are you already coming at my candidate? We have not gone through...
No, I just said the Marquette grad.
We have not had a campaign speech with debate yet. That is coming up next.
Yeah, debate comes later. I just, you know, it's reactions. Oh, my God. Aaron Rodgers, vice president, what? Yeah.
Kyle Wallace with the last pick for president here.
You know, for my last pick for president, it's going to be a shocker here, right? And we talked about following trends in America. And the most shocking person is somebody you should draft. And you know what? I think this individual will be a great leader, and his name is Mark Samora. Chewy is going to be
okay.
The president. Yes, the president.
Oh, wow.
Now,
and you believe that?
I believe that.
I will say Chewy will be able to intimidate other countries quite well. He's a sizable guy.
Yeah, I'll give my explanation coming up.
Okay. Well, we are doing a snake draft, so you have the next pick, Kyle, for your vice president with Mark Chmura.
I'm getting the old gang back together. As a VP, I'm going to go with Gabe Neitzel. I think Gabe Neitzel will be a nice, steady, consistent hand. So I'm going to go with Gabe Neitzel. So I got my
usually the president golfs a lot. I don't know if the vice president does, but Gabe Neitzel does fit that presidential golfing.
Sure does.
Yeah, yeah. Next in line.
Next, my VP running mate with Jen Latta, Brian Bulaga. I feel like I have a great combination here. Jen Latta. I think the women's vote is important. I think that Jen is very opinionated as well. It can stand up to and lead the nation. But I think she may not reach the heart of America. And the heart of America is Iowa. Where Brian Bulaga went to school. He will represent the Midwest. He will represent those farmers. Jen Latta ultimately has a contract with Big ESPN. I have the big cities out east covered with, or this isn't campaign speech time. I picked Brian Bulaga.
Yeah. I forgot. I was going to lead it in.
I know. You guys like it.
I was just waiting for it. I was going to just say, you know, he said he loves women, but then he could beat Caitlin Clark, but, you know.
That has nothing to do. Athletics and my athletic achievements have nothing to do with who will make a great ESPN Wisconsin presidential candidate. Chris Larson. Homer's running. Who else? Who's the oldest one left?
Homer's running mate. I'm not going to go old, though. I'm going to go to the more young side of it. I'm going to go Tory Lowe is going to be Homer's running mate.
What a ticket.
That ticket is going to either flop or it's going to be amazing.
No, that ticket mimics...
mimics America right now.
If Aaron Rodgers goes BP,
nobody likes what we have right now.
If they didn't like what we have right now, they wouldn't be voting for the same people.
That's
again.
Very true.
Yeah, that's true.
All right, so from my calculation, remaining, I've got Jason Wilde, Alex Stroh, Jim Rutledge, I've got Hamilton, I've got
John Anderson.
Wait, Jesse Nelson?
Oh, yeah, Jesse Nelson.
No.
Wait a minute.
On the ballot just so his name would be on there and then left out.
Matt Hamilton, Jim Rutledge, John Anderson.
I know what Brad is dealing with internally.
I know what I'm going to go with. I'm also going to try to hit the heart of the nation. We need to get our youth voters out there. We need some energy. My VP for Mark Tauscher, Alex Stroh.
Wow.
You picked an idiot. No idiot.
You know how many scandals Alex Stroh will be in?
I'm going to give you my scandal.
White House is...
I'm going to give you my pitch.
Going to be jacked up on Mountain Dew.
You're going to be wanting... That's what this country needs. A little bit of energy. A little bit of excitement. No, I'm going to hold on for my speech. Because this is going to be the ticket that brings America back to prosperity. Or keeps us in prosperity, whatever side of the aisle you're on.
800-990-3776. 800-990-ESPN. What would be your ESPN Wisconsin president and vice president? Kyrie is picked to head up NASA. That's pretty good.
That is good.
Lot of reaction coming in on who people would pick for their presidential election of ESPN Wisconsin. To recap, Brad Nortman has Mark Tauscher as his president and a big liability, in my opinion, in his VP of Alex Stroh, leaving off John Anderson, leaving off Jason Wilde, leaving off some high-quality names to go with somebody who is young and inexperienced.
We're going to reach the youth.
Chris Larson trying to go with the most political climate he could based off of... what we have out there in the world. Homer for president. Steve the Homer, true. And Tory Lowe of 101.7 The Truth and Tory Lowe Tuesdays on Kyle Brust-Nortman. Ben Brust with Jen Latta for president and Brian Bulaga as vice president. Kyle Wallace has Mark Chmura and Gabe Neitzel. We give our campaign speeches and debate for our candidates next on Kyle Bruston-Ortman, and we will get this on the poll for you guys to vote. 800-990-3776. We also hear from you. If you're on the line, stay there. We'll get to you next.
This is Kyle Bruston-Ortman.
Milwaukee County, you need to shovel the pathway to the lake, okay? I had to step through snow
to
get to the lake.
I think Kyle's the Karen of the show.
He's high maintenance, for sure.
I think Kyle pays taxes in the county of Milwaukee that just went up, so I expect for this stuff to be popped.
On ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com. Football Guy.
What the hell happened to Bucky on your hat?
Football Guy.
A lot of wear and tear for old B.
Coming at it from different views.
I'm just saying, he's well-worn. I mean, his face is missing. Okay, well, it's probably time for me to freshen that up. Bucky wants to flip you off right now.
Wildy and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Also sponsored by Coors Light. Weekdays 9 to noon on 94.5 ESPN. And available wherever you get your podcasts with Wisconsin On Demand.
To be labeled as bourbon, a whiskey must be distilled from a mash that is at least 51% made of this grain.
What is corn?
Correct.
I'll take liquor for 800.
A cocktail of rum, grapefruit juice, lime juice, simple syrup, and maraschino liqueur is a daiquiri named for this American author.
Who is Ernest Hemingway?
Correct again, Marie. You're on a roll.
Liquor for 1,000, Ken.
Taking a shot of whiskey and immediately chugging a beer is a quote-unquote recipe for this drink, named because it was once served to workers ending their shifts.
What is a Boilermaker?
Unbelievable. Tell us, how do you know so much?
Well, Ken, I am from Discount Liquor, where we have an encyclopedia-like knowledge of all things alcohol. We've been a family-owned and operated business since 1960, and we've all grown up with alcohol as a second language. Our business has literally served multiple generations of Wisconsinites. In Milwaukee, on 51st and Oklahoma, and in downtown Waukesha, on Main and Barstow.
Discount Liquor.
Life's better with American Family Insurance, because our home policies help protect your dreams and come with peace of mind. Save up to 25% by bundling home, auto, and life. American Family Insurance. Get a quote, find an agent at amfam.com.
Products not available in every state. Discounts may not apply to all coverages on an auto or home policy. Discounts do not apply to life insurance policies. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating companies, American Family Life Insurance Company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
This is the time of year to enjoy your life. Stop letting that pain in your joints keep you from doing what you want to do this spring. Call QC Kinetics now. QC Kinetics is the nation's leader in regenerative medicine. I'm talking about joint pain relief with no surgery, no drugs, and no downtime. It is a fact. QC Kinetics is literally transforming lives. Their advanced treatments harness your body's own ability to restore and repair that damaged joint tissue. Pro athletes have been doing this for decades, but now this life-changing treatment is available for you, so you can walk and run, climb stairs, play golf, move again, pain-free. No pain pills, no risky surgery. This is an all-natural solution. QC Kinetics has tens of thousands of satisfied patients who have reclaimed their mobility. Take action now. Live your best life this spring and summer, and it's a great use of your tax refund check. Call QC Kinetics for a free consultation. Call 414-285-3474. That's 414-285-3474. 414-285-3474.
UW Credit Union presents the Student Athlete of the Week, supporting local student athletes as they grow on the field, in the classroom, and in the community. UW Credit Union is here for every you. Learn more at uwcu.org. Here's Ashton Rock with a UW Credit Union Student Athlete of the Week.
This week's UW Credit Union Student Athlete of the Week goes to Marquette High's Nolan Minasalli, the senior Hilltoppers basketball player, a big part of why they are heading to state this season. In the team's 64-58 win over West Allis Central last weekend, Minasalli added 17 points, including a pair of pivotal free throws late to extend Marquette's lead. On the season, and including the playoffs, the 6'5 senior averaged 21.8 points per game, including six 30-plus point performances. The third-seeded Hilltoppers will take on two-seed Kettle Moraine on Friday night in state semifinal action, that one happening at the Kohl Center. Minasalli will continue his hoops career at Division I St. Thomas in Minnesota next season.
This is Kyle Bruston-Ortman, KBN, on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
Loosen up your body, baby, come on. Loosen up your body, baby, come on.
We have selected our ESPN Wisconsin talents for Kyle Bresser-Norton's presidential election. Brad Norton with the first and eighth pick out of like 13, 14 people to select. Went with Mark Tauscher first overall. Let's be honest. Was anyone not picking Tausch first overall?
I would have.
Yeah, he's a good pick, man.
Yep. Yeah, strong candidate.
But with that, we had to make sure, since he was a heavy favorite, that it was a snake draft and Brad would get the last pick. And I still think it's shocking that he chose Alex Stroph of ESPN Madison's Mr. Irrelevant podcast and live show on YouTube over the likes of John Anderson of ESPN, Jason Wilde of Wilde and Tausch, Rutledge and Hamilton of ESPN Madison. Find it very interesting. Rutledge and Hamilton. Hamilton having a Olympic gold medal representing
sure.
his country.
He sure does.
Alex Stroph does not. And then we have Chris Larson, who went with the most 2024 presidential candidates of all time. Steve the Homer True, a grumpy old man at times, who would do really well in a debate, representing like they do in the debates now. His running mate, Tori Lowe of 101.7 The Truth. They would have some sick slogans. I could tell you that one. Powerful. Oh, wow.
Pow.
Tori Lowe would be Homer's hype man.
Wow.
I go with Jen Latta for president, Brian Belaga for vice president. Kyle Wallace ends up going with, got it written down here, Mark Chmura and Gabe Neitzel, bringing the band back together that was once a morning show on 94.5 ESPN. I turn it over to the first overall selection, Brad Norton, for his initial campaign speech. We'll keep these to 45 seconds to 1 minute. Please time, Chris, and leave room for rebuttals for others.
Let's start with the ticket of Tausch Stroph 2024, Mark Tauscher. Man, he knows how to lead. He knows how to be part of the team. Mark Tauscher, he connects with the masses. He is so likable, but not only likable, he connects with you, but he's an outside-the-box thinker. He definitely is a critical thinker who is also independent. No one is going to be able to sway him one way or the other. He is going to be able to focus on his convictions, but also connect with people. And that is why Mark Tauscher is the perfect presidential candidate. But Alex Stroph, running mate. We're talking about energy, invigoration, reaching the youth. He's a slick talker, and he can move people to vote. I don't care if it needs a performance enhancer like Mountain Dew. Alex Stroph is the ultimate hype man, and he will help Mark Tauscher get the job done. The campaign slogan of these two movers and shakers is, "We represent the people because we are the people."
Oh, good God.
Tausch and Stroph, 2024. I'm ready to cast my vote right now. Thank you very much.
Yeah, I mean, you just messed up with the Stroph thing. And the hard part is Brad, where you got hurt is you weren't able to separate your personal feelings. You and Stroph are very close. I know he's been to your house. I know you love him as a person. I do, too. I think he's great. But he's way too immature to handle the duties of a vice president. He's way too immature to handle the duties of the press secretary.
Yeah, but this is a demographics push, right? We got to get the youth out there and vote.
The youth don't even like him.
No, the youth like him. They're going to like him. He is the ultimate hype man. He's going to build Tausch up to allow Tausch to be the best possible president. Tausch is leading the way. Stroph is hyping him up along the side.
Yeah, see, nobody likes controversy like that, right? We like good controversy, not bad controversy. Stroph would just be an embarrassment to everybody.
Yeah. It's a bad look.
So hard.
Come on,
not only for
America, but for ESPN Wisconsin.
Wow.
You want that man representing ESPN Wisconsin?
If we're being honest,
yeah, I'll take a shot here. He's got his own show that's on digital only, not radio. ESPN Wisconsin thinks about him.
That goes to show that he is on this list.
You've worked with him before.
Yeah.
You've worked with him.
He's taking care of his people.
He's a hype man. He's going to make Tausch be the best possible Tausch you can be.
Nepotism.
Yeah, I didn't expect it out of you.
These are absurd.
Actually, I would expect it out of him.
Absurd.
This makes sense.
Former
Mr. Yuppity.
Yeah, yuppie guy like yourself.
Chris Larson, your speech for Homer and Tori Lowe.
All right, Steve the Homer True. He's got the experience. He's been around the block. He's been in different parts of the country. He's durable. He's someone who's been in the game as long as anybody and has made his mark. Yes, he's old, but he's not that old. He's not as old as anybody else nowadays who's actually running for president or vice president. He's a man of the people.
I heard that on the Homer Hour, he likes weed. So if you're into that sort of thing, he's talking about it up in Michigan.
Legalize it, according to Homer, apparently. You see it every day from his tweets on X. He's a man of the people. He accepts everyone and follows everyone. He allows everyone to have a voice, as you can see by his followers. And if you challenge him, he'll say thank you and leave you with a smile on top of it. He already has a slogan as well. His old baby will be known around the country. Likewise, Tory Lowe. He'll bring in the African-American vote. He's young. He's hip. He's out in the community.
He's making
his mark as well. He's younger than Homer. He's got his own slogan, too. He's got a myriad of slogans from his, oh, wow, to powerful. And, hey, Ebony and Ivory living together in perfect harmony to create a more tremendous country for us all.
You're going to say greater America.
That's it.
That was a really good speech,
Chris.
That
was actually a good speech. That was good.
Although the candidates are not going to work, the speech was good. The speech was good.
That's a conspiracy ticket.
That's a conspiracy ticket.
That is a conspiracy ticket.
I would like to talk now about the president and vice president of my selection of Jen Latta and Brian Balaga. Can you think of two more people that represent the Americans as a whole and reach everyone as a whole? Jen Latta is a feature reporter for ESPN College Game Day. You know what her stories do? They move you. They reach you. They make you cry. They make you laugh. They make you smile. They make you feel everything that you want to feel every day. That's what I want in a leader for this country. I don't want to divide us. I want someone who's been able to tell stories, to bring us together, no matter what your identity is and no matter what you believe in. She can bring the people together. She is a mother of three, a hardworking mother of three, balancing work and life, knows what it's like to be growing a family and trying to provide in the climate that we are in this economy. She will do whatever it takes to make a better world, not just for hers, but for the future generations to come. And her running mate, Brian Balaga, the Packers Hall of Famer, a trenches guy, literally and figuratively. When you think about Brian Balaga, he will be half bodyguard. He will be standing next to Jen Latta. She will be protected like he protected on the Green Bay Packers. He is a representation of the backbone of America, the farmers, because we can't forget the farmers of America. Brian Balaga. Iowa, Brian Balaga. Iowa, Brian Balaga. Florida, we have all parts. He's living in Florida right now. He's lived in the Midwest. He's lived in Green Bay. Jen Latta works for ESPN. She's got the East Coast. We got the heart of America. We got the big cities of America. Forget the West Coast.
Are you finished?
I mean, I could go on forever.
Well over the buzzer. Well over it.
Well, we listen to everybody else give
so
their spiel.
So do the presidential candidates in debates.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Thank you. I'm trying to close them off.
You clearly saved the best for last. And I just want to let you all know, when you think about representation, when you think about what looks like you, when you think about when you want somebody to represent you, you need someone who isn't afraid to speak their mind. That's what we need in times like this. Somebody not afraid to tell it like it is. Somebody willing to be controversial. Somebody that is willing to say, you know what, it may be worth getting a little bit of a penalty or taking out other radio stations if it makes sure everybody here wins. That's what you are looking for, and that's exactly what you get. But also, you don't only get all of that. You get a successful athlete. You get a successful businessman. You get a successful radio personality as well. And most importantly, you get a lovable man. Now, I'll finish when it talks about president and who we should be electing. When you all think back to your childhoods or your young adulthood, you remember this guy scoring touchdowns, this guy winning games for you. Maybe you, like Brad or like me, you had his picture on your wall as a kid. Yeah. That's the guy you want. You want that nostalgia.
Oh,
you want somebody to be a little unhinged.
So sad.
You
This is cringy.
You want somebody well-traveled. You want somebody.
Talk
like
about
our
your VP.
Man, Mark Shamour, to be your future president.
That's it?
And then the VP?
Oh, my gosh. He's not. Yeah.
No. There's more. Can I just go?
You got the buzzer.
Nobody said anything when you went.
Yeah, you guys are disqualified for going over the buzzer.
My goodness. And I'll get to my VP.
Keep it short.
I'll keep it short. Listen to this. He's paid his dues. He has dedicated his life to serving the people of ESPN Wisconsin. Has been working here since he was an illegal, since he was 16 years old. He's been working for ESPN
Wisconsin. We already
have
enough illegals.
He's polished. He's passionate, and he's ready to step up whenever called upon. He does ESPN in the morning. He does ESPN at night. He does ESPN National. He does it all the time. And you add him with Chewy, you put the dream team back together. I'm telling you guys right now, the person that you want to be your president and your vice president is Chewy. And also you want Mr. ESPN Wisconsin, Mr. Looking Good himself, Mr. Gabe Neisel.
There it is, the ESPN Wisconsin presidential election. Let's put it up on Twitter, at KBN ESPN. The president with running mate will have KBN Nation vote on it. 800-990-3776. We will get to your calls, we will get to your texts, and we will get to your responses on the text line and on YouTube. This is Kyle Bruston-Ortman figuring out who would be the best ESPN Wisconsin president.
You're listening to Kyle Bruston-Ortman.
If I was as tall and as talented as you, if I could shoot as well as you could, both them teams would have won. Because you know what? You got the, you did a fake punch, you said, in the Rose Bowl.
Yeah.
And I would have did fake point. I would have took it to the house. I would have scored a dang touchdown.
On ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
Don't put your life on hold to earn a degree. Lakeland University has a long history of making students' dreams come true since 1862. Build a schedule that meets your needs with options for 7 and 12-week courses, evening classes, and the ability to join classes remotely. Lakeland University is Wisconsin's leader in evening and online education. They have a main campus in Sheboygan County and 6 centers throughout the whole state. Lakeland University, affordable, quality, flexible. Find out your next steps at info.lakeland.edu.
ESPN Wisconsin's Mark Tauscher here, and there is one thing I think everyone can agree on. Potholes stink. And this year's weather will make it one of the worst years yet. Well, Johnson & Sons Paving is ready to take on the challenge with a team that has over 2 decades of experience. When the potholes pop up in your asphalt, Johnson & Sons Paving can patch or replace the whole area. Book an appointment now at johnsonandsonspaving.com. Get that appointment booked before May 31st, and you might even see Old T on the job site for a visit. Find full contest details at ESPN Wisconsin. WisconsinContest.com.
Another MVP has joined the roster at Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin.
Dr. Ryan Stefanchek.
Board certified in sports medicine, physical medicine, and rehabilitation, Dr. Stefanchek specializes in non-operative treatment of the spine, chronic pain, all joints, all musculoskeletal problems, and more, emphasizing holistic care first, with a focus on diet, sleep, stress management, and social connections for a patient's well-being. At Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin, there is a difference.
Hey, it's Kyle Walls for Universal Windows Direct. I've been telling you that windows from Universal perform better and last longer. Call today at 414-410-2000 to schedule your free in-home estimate today. And for every 2 windows you buy, you get the next 2 free. Plus, a free upgrade to triple pane glass, and they'll double your energy tax credit. Restrictions do apply. Tell them I told you to call and get an additional $250 off your next project. For the last windows you'll ever need, go to UniversalWindowsDirect.com. And like me, you'll be saying, I love my windows.
A season of award-winning golf at Sweetgrass and Sage Run is on the horizon. The Island Resort and Casino's stay-and-play golf packages are booking fast, with choice dates available early in the week. After your rounds, visit the Drift Spa for a relaxing or targeted massage session. And enjoy dinner at Horizon's scenic top-floor steakhouse. So many reasons to take a drive. Book your stay-and-play golf package today. Visit islandresortgolf.com.
Hi, this is John Neal, CPA, founder of Right Choice Tax Resolution, and best-selling author on how to have less stress with the IRS. It's 2024 and an election year. The politicians are out there promising things they won't deliver. One thing is certain, taxes are what pays for those promises. The IRS collects those taxes, and man, can they be brutal. My latest book has advice on what to do to avoid trouble with the IRS. We help you file back tax returns, get liens released, set up payment plans, represent you in audits, and get penalties reduced or eliminated. Some recent clients we helped include getting a $40,000 tax bill reduced by $32,000, filing a 2020 tax return to get a $7,000 refund, and negotiating a payment plan for $250 a month on a $30,000 tax bill. Make the right choice. Go to rightchoicetax.us to book a call or in-person meeting right now. We know you want to take the first step in getting the IRS off your back so you can live again. That's rightchoicetax.us.
Hi, I'm Natalie Shepard.
And I'm Jessup Reisbeck from the CBS 58 News at 10.
We hear it all the time from viewers. Television news is too negative.
That's why we're trying something different at CBS 58. In our newscasts, we focus on what's important to Southeast Wisconsin, and that's not necessarily crime.
We want you to know the great things happening in our hometowns as well.
What's going
to
help solve problems here and uplift our viewers?
We are your hometown station, and that's the type of news we're going to bring to you.
Join us every night at 10 on the CBS 58 News.
This is Kyle Bruston-Nortman, KBN, on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
On Twitter at KBN ESPN, which ESPN Wisconsin ticket would you vote for, president and vice president? Right now, Mark Tauscher and Strofe leading the way at 43%. What'd you call this ticket? The conspiracy ticket?
That would be the conspiracy ticket, yes.
Homer and Tori Lowe at 10.8%. Jen Latta and Brian Bulaga at 35%. And Mark Chmura and Gabe Neitzel at 10%. Votes will continue to come in, 800-990-3776. We took ourselves out of it because obviously, you know, I actually would rather be a vice president, to be honest, than the president.
Oh, yeah.
Who would want to be the president?
Literally. Yeah. Vice president, you get all the nice stuff, stay out of the
VP.
Spotlight.
Yeah, you get everything. You get the Secret Service.
Maybe that's why it was perfect that you picked Gabe as your vice president, because he can go play golf all the time.
Ron and the Key, welcome in to Kyle Bruston-Nortman. Your feedback and on our candidates and speeches.
I mean, I don't know why somebody didn't just go full troll and combine Rutledge with Tausch so you could just have a ticket that wouldn't even agree on anything. But I think I would have gone, you know, celebrity. You guys did smart there. But money wins. Go old generational money. Go your own president. Craig, and then somebody who's willing to tell whatever he thinks the story needs to be, no matter what he believes in or whatever.
That's where you're wrong. That's not going to happen. What Craig wants, Craig's going to do, and that's why he's the CEO, Ron.
No, I mean Greg. Greg.
Oh, Greg Scalzo.
He can be Aaron Rodgers' number one supporter.
Oh yeah, no, I don't.
Craig and Greg.
Well, thank you, Ron and the Key, for your feedback.
Well, you know, every house in America will have a dog.
What do you mean? You think Craig Karmazin would give everyone a dog, you're saying?
Yeah, our workplace has a dog, so, I mean, why doesn't everybody in America have a dog?
Well, why are you taking him out? He wasn't even a part of the exercise. We'll continue the voting, get to the responses, but I do want to get to the KBN Academy.
In radio, our goal's pretty simple.
Just so you know, you really suck.
Have an A show or an F show.
Hey, I'll decide who sucks around here.
The same goes for topics in this next segment. This is the KBN Academy.
Those that can't do, teach.
It is the KBN Academy, where Chris is going to ask us some questions, and we got to answer A or F. I'm Ben Brust, Brad Nortman, Kyle Wallace. We are your professors. We can only give an A or F, no B, C's, or D's, or else in between. Chris Larson, you're going to ask the questions. Take it away.
All right, guys, let's kick it off here. A Pittsburgh bowling alley is hosting a nude bowling night coming up in April. The event has been at Crafton Ingram Lanes twice a year for the past 3 years. Nudity is required, with the exception that women can wear bottoms and sexual activity is not permitted. A or F, you would participate in this kind of event.
Ooh, it's an A or an F.
Who wants to go first?
I mean, I'm considering it. Oh, so let me think about
it. Okay, while you think about it, I'll say an F, of course. I got no interest to see a bunch of random people naked, and particularly bowling. That is the most absurd way to view a bunch of other people naked. Not only do I not need to see that, I don't want to see it both.
What do you want to see them do then, Brad?
That's why number one was so critical. Not only do I not want to see that, all these naked people, I only need to see one naked person in my life. My wife.
I didn't see himself looking in the mirror.
I don't know myself yet. I don't need to see anyone else. And if I was the place,
why'd you pause so long?
Because I was wondering where am I going to go with this. I said it.
My wife.
I said it without thinking about it. It's still true. But no. And then if it is,
I don't even want to look at myself naked. I just want to look at my wife.
I don't need to see people doing this bowling. Gross.
Yeah, this is America's weird, man. This is a big F. The last thing I want to do is be reaching for a bowling ball and then somebody squatting over. What the heck is that swinging? I don't need none of that. So, no, this is stupid. This should be illegal. This should be banned. I want to call the police personally on this. How can it be legal to walk around butt naked around a bowling alley? Like, that, just the visual of that just seems terrible.
Look at those naked bike rides that people are going
on. Which I disagree on, too.
Yeah, like, that's disgusting,
put some clothes on, people. They just coming around
naked. You came out of your mama nude.
Yeah, and then they put clothes. I've been clothed ever since. Like, that was indecent exposure is a real thing. I don't think this is not right. Something's wrong with Pittsburgh. This is stupid. This is an F. Put some clothes on, people.
Yeah.
And I encourage sexual activity in that case.
Okay.
Okay. All right.
Hey.
Make it dirtier, I guess.
Hey, if you're going to be naked, do it all.
I'm an F here. Now, I am pro nudity. I do like, I hate that I'm wearing this suit and these pants with this belt. Everything's tight. Like, I just want to be free. But I don't want to go to an event with, like, random people that want to be nude. You know, like, if that makes sense, I'm pro nudity, but I don't want to go to this bowling event with these random people that are showing up. I guess I'm caught in a little bit of a pickle here.
I'll just say for the record, I'm sure thankful that you have clothes on, Ben. I know it sounds like you want to be a nudist, but I'm sure thankful you have clothes on.
If it was socially acceptable to come to work, come to GKB in the nude or, you know, clothed lightly, Ben would take us up on that. He would come in his drawers. Not even drawers. He doesn't wear drawers. He would come in some basketball short shorts and a t-shirt every single day with flip-flops all, and probably take his shirt off because he got too hot here. Hey, guys, you mind if I take my shirt off? Like, yeah, I'm not comfortable with that.
Ron in the Key chimes in, being naked is better than the ugly orange shirt that you wore. Jacob chimes in, have you seen all the people riding around Madison for the naked bike ride? One time I got stuck in traffic and, like, you know, they just take over. Like, you can't go anywhere. It's like, it's almost like it's a protest, but it's not a protest. They just literally, they're everywhere, so you can't drive your car.
Well, and whenever I've, like, either, like, been at, like, a nude beach or something like that, or seen this in the public, it's just
weird.
Wait,
you've been to a nude beach?
I've been to Europe, man. I've been to Europe. I've been to St. Bart's.
Did you go nude?
I was not nude. I've just seen other people being nude.
And, Why would you go to a nude beach and not get nude?
It's Europeans. I don't know. I can't. That's why I live in this great country. But every time I see it, I'm just struck as, like, it's just bizarre. It's just weird. There's nothing even, like, enjoyable about it. When it's in public like that, it's just weird to me.
Feeling free. Mm-hmm. The only thing that I think about with that is, like, having to have more areas to put suntan lotion on and not burn, especially
that's
sensitive
true.
Areas.
That's true.
Next, Chris.
All I know is that Tauschen, the ticket of Tauschen Strofe would accept nude beaches, I'm assuming, Brad, so.
Not if they consult me.
All right, moving on here. We'll finish off KBN Academy. During the men's Horizon League tournament game between Oakland and Purdue Fort Wayne, some fans and attendants in the student section got their nipples waxed and even got tattoos to distract free throw shooters. I guess waving the big heads around are no longer acceptable. I got to up the ante a little bit. ARF, you've gotten some parts of your body waxed before.
No, but I'm open to it. Like, I don't want to be super, like, I'm not super hairy, and so if I get super hairy, I'm not going to want to be super hairy. So I'm open to a little bit of waxing.
Yeah, I've never had anything waxed before. I'm not super hairy either, so I've never felt the need for it. But if somebody is and wanted to, I'd say, yeah, go for it. If I was, I would consider it.
You got quite a bit of arm hair there going.
Yeah, you do got a lot of arm hair.
But it's not, what do you say? You think I should wax it?
Well, no, we just can't trust if you're hairy or not.
Yeah, I don't know.
I'm like
me and Ben
hairy.
Are pretty,
yeah.
Pretty
I'm
smooth.
Like a little,
yeah.
I'm like a
but
little
this,
child.
You wouldn't consider this hairy. This is like moderately hairy.
I'd consider it like I'm scared to go near it.
Oh,
like,
something's
growing in that hair.
There's something there. There's definitely something there.
Okay, I'll take it. There's a lot of masculinity over here.
No, never been shaved
got a lot
or anything.
Of testosterone.
Yeah.
I want to get a tattoo.
No, I don't want a tattoo. Don't want to be pierced. I don't need that. I was blessed with not a lot of hair here and naturally groomed. So nothing needs to be waxed over here. So I'll pass on that.
That's it for KBN Academy. 800-990-3776. 800-990-3776. A lot of people very, very passionate about the ESPN Wisconsin president and vice president draft. You can vote on that on Twitter at KBN ESPN. As the results right now, Tausch and Strofe are now below Jen and Balaga. Balaga and Jen, my selection, 41.5%. Tausch and Strofe, 39.8%. You'd be running away with this if you had you could have put Jesse Nelson's name next to Tausch and been better.
I don't think that's true. First of all, you can't prove that. And second of all, I think some of that vote was the youth that Alex Strofe is trying to
Mark degrade. Chmura and Gabe Neitzel, last place at 8%, and Homer and Tori Lowe at 10%. We'll continue to talk through this, as well as a whole lot more. Goody making moves, Green Bay Packers, Josh Jacobs. Kind of moving on from Aaron Jones, but I want to get the pulse of Kyle Wallace next.
This is Kyle Brustin Nortman, KBN.
You throw hands?
Do I throw hands?
With T.O.
Will I? No. I throw hands with Andre the Giant, man.
I love you, Will. That's good. Lewis from the North Side. The North Side always knows.
On ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
Join the Truth Team on Saturday, April 13th for our third annual Tori Lowe Community Cleanup. We want you to go to truthcommunitycleanup.com to sign up and be a volunteer to help keep Milwaukee clean. Everyone who joins will get a free lunch provided by Cousin Subs. Register today at truthcommunitycleanup.com. That is truthcommunitycleanup.com to clean and beautify our city together. The Truth Community Cleanup is sponsored by Cousin Subs.
Hey, this is Jen Latta from Jen, Gabe, and Chewy. One of the best decisions I made recently was getting an infrared sauna from Good Health Saunas. They're a local business that's been around for 2 decades, based right in Appleton and Waukesha. Good Health Saunas are easy to install, cost as little as 25 cents a day, and include a true lifetime warranty. Even firefighters all across the country trust Good Health Saunas for sweating smoke out of their skin after fighting fire. Learn more at goodhealthsaunas.com. That's goodhealthsaunas.com.
UW Credit Union presents the Student Athlete of the Week, supporting local student athletes as they grow on the field, in the classroom, and in the community. UW Credit Union is here for every you. Learn more at uwcu.org. Here's Ashton Rotman with the UW Credit Union Student Athlete of the Week.
This week's UW Credit Union Student Athlete of the Week goes to Marquette High's Nolan Minasali. The senior Hilltoppers basketball player, a big part of why they are heading to state this season. In the team's 64-58 win over West Allis Central last weekend, Minasali added 17 points, including a pair of pivotal free throws late to extend Marquette's lead. On the season, and including the playoffs, the 6'5 senior averaged 21.8 points per game, including 6 30-plus point performances. The third-seeded Hilltoppers will take on 2-seed Kettle Moraine on Friday night in state semifinal action, that one happening at the Kohl Center. Minasali will continue his hoops career at Division I St. Thomas in Minnesota next season.
Come see Thanalysis live from Potawatomi Casino Hotel on Friday, March 22nd.
Hey, welcome to another Thanalysis show. And we are coming up into this podcast.
Be there for the first ever live show for Thanasis as he's joined by his brother, none other than the Greek freak, Giannis Antetokounmpo.
I took off my shoes and I was like, go crazy, go hoop. That's all it was.
Get your tickets now at taliveshow.com. Thanalysis live at Potawatomi Casino Hotel on March 22nd. taliveshow.com.
This is the time of year to enjoy your life. Stop letting that pain in your joints keep you from doing what you want to do this spring. Call QC Kinetics now. QC Kinetics is the nation's leader in regenerative medicine. I'm talking about joint pain relief with no surgery, no drugs, and no downtime. It is a fact. QC Kinetics is literally transforming lives. Their advanced treatments harness your body's own ability to restore and repair that damaged joint tissue. Pro athletes have been doing this for decades, but now this life-changing treatment is available for you. so you can walk and run, climb stairs, play golf, move again, pain-free. No pain pills, no risky surgery. This is an all-natural solution. QC Kinetics has tens of thousands of satisfied patients who have reclaimed their mobility. Take action now. Live your best life this spring and summer. And it's a great use of your tax refund check. Call QC Kinetics for a free consultation. Call 414-285-3474. That's 414-285-3474. 414-285-3474.
The moment you've been waiting for is here. Eagle Sports Range is officially open for action. It's Wisconsin's largest indoor range, offering unlimited range time in 40 lanes, which include 20-20-yard lanes and 20-50-yard lanes. And no reservations needed. Just show up and let the fun begin. With a staggering selection of 100 firearm rentals to use, every visit is a new adventure. Eagle Sports Range is also a go-to for education. Take advantage of their concealed carry classes and gun safety courses. Safety first, excitement second. Visit them out in Cudahy or online at eaglesportsrange.com. Eagle Sports Range, where education meets exhilaration.
You're listening to Kyle Brust and Nortman, KBN, on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
.com 800-990-3776, the ESPN Wisconsin Talk and Text Line. You're listening to Kyle Brust and Nortman across ESPN Wisconsin. I'm Ben Brust, alongside the Packer backer Kyle Wallace, Brad Nortman, longtime NFL punter, second place Brad, and Chris Larson running the show. I do want to get to some sound from earlier this morning on 94.5 ESPN's Jen, Gabe, and Chewy, because I, for one, and like many others, believe that Goody, because of a lot of things he did last year, have opened up the opportunity for him to do some things this year that we haven't seen the Packers do. And with that, people are still upset. And I don't get it. And I like what Chewy had to say.
Are there still Goody haters?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Well, there shouldn't be. There shouldn't be. Because the reason they're in the position they are to where they can attack free agency is because he nailed the offensive side of the ball. Right? If he didn't nail it, they would still be plugging holes on that side, where now, with a little bit of help in the offensive line, they're set for a couple years until they start having to pay some of those young receivers and tight ends.
That was Mark Chmura, Packers Hall of Famer, earlier. And, you know, Kyle, you've had a lot to digest from the news on Monday where everything broke, from Josh Jacobs to Aaron Jones release to Xavier McKinney to the next morning, Aaron Jones signing with the Vikings. Where are you at with Goody?
Consider me, consider me a Goody reforming hater, right? I'm in the part where I'm reforming because there was a lot of hate that I had towards Goody. And the issue that I have with what you said and what Chewy said is this, is that, yes, he has done some good things, but he talked about in the last couple years. You're not judged based off the last couple years. He came in as the general manager in 2018. And so I need to evaluate from 2018 until now. And so based off his full track record, there is some level of scrutiny that we should have when it comes to Goody. His draft classes as a whole, they haven't been great. We talked about it many, many times during the regular season, is the fact that Goody did not put the Packers in a position at that time early in the season to be successful. Now, eventually those guys came around and we found out that this last draft class is doing really well. But when you look at his draft classes as a whole, they have come up short. They have not been good enough. When you look at his first round picks as a whole, they have not been great enough. They have not contributed enough. We're talking about the Packers need to find a field tilter on defense, and all they've done is basically drafted on defense since he's become the general manager. And guess what? They haven't been able to find that field tilter. That falls on Goody. He is the man who selected the players. And also, at the end of the day, the Packers have not got to their ultimate goal, and their ultimate goal of success is winning championships, building a title contender. Goody has not consistently been able to do that. He did not do everything he could in order to put a championship caliber around Aaron Rodgers each and every year that he had him, and for that, that is why I am still a reforming hater from Brian Gutekunst.
Don't be hating.
Wow, that's powerful. I was never a Goody hater. I would just say, Goody, like, you need to continue to prove to me that you deserve to be a top 10 GM. You continue to put this team in a championship form. And you're right. There were times when early in his career, late in Aaron Rodgers' career, it didn't seem like they were yoked in the same thing. It felt like Goody wasn't particularly in win-now mode when they needed to be in win-now mode. But, guys, if you're going to build a team, which is what Goody has done, what are you going to start with? You're going to start with a QB1. You're going to then move to offensive line. Then you're going to want an edge rusher. Then you're going to want skill players. Those are the bedrock of what NFL teams are nowadays. A starting quarterback, good offensive line, edge rushers, and skill players. Goody has done all four of those. Jordan Love, offensive lineman, edge rusher, and Rashawn Gary, and all these skill players. So he's proven that he can build a team. Now, did he equip Aaron Rodgers perfectly to win a Super Bowl? Those teams were pretty good. They won 13 games. I mean, they certainly were eligible to be able to do it.
How many of those games were on the arm? How many of those games were on the arm of Aaron Rodgers?
Okay, I don't want to dive too deep into this because we can have this conversation every day for the rest of our lives.
Don't be hating.
But Brad, I mean, you said it when it came to going over the 1-4 NFC Championship record. We went through the games. We looked at Rodgers' playoff performances. They were okay. They weren't great. And ultimately, it is a lot to do with him not elevating the team past obstacles that they had. Now, and there are some situations where Atlanta in 17?
2016, I believe.
They had no chance.
Correct.
2019, no chance. But in 2020 and 2021, and I know 21, they didn't go to an NFC Championship game. That was like when they were humming. 2020, they had the best offense of the NFL. They had the number one red zone offense in the NFL, and they didn't get it done against Tom Brady and the Buccaneers. The next year, the defense showed up, and Rodgers didn't push that offense over the hump over the Niners when he was asking for a home game at Lambeau Field as a one seed. And they had the bye, right? Like, so all the scenarios were there for Rodgers. I think Goody played a part. I think Rodgers played a part. But like we said, I'd probably put it more on, if you look at all the quarterbacks that have had success in the playoffs from a stats perspective, and there's more stories to be told, he didn't play his best football in those games.
And either way you phrase it, it was an arranged marriage between Goody and Rodgers, right? They just didn't see eye to eye. Their personalities didn't get together. Now, they should have been able to, both of them, put those aside and work towards something which was a Super Bowl victory for this team during that window. There's no excuse that they didn't even get to a Super Bowl. But since Brian Gutekunst has been able to put his fingerprints on this team, there's no doubt that he can show that he is a team builder. He just didn't work well with what he had, but when he's kind of tearing it down and building it back from scratch, he has been able to hit every main position that you want to hit in the climate of today's league. So he is a good GM. He's proving that he can do it.
I want to continue the conversation because I think we, you know, in terms of proving to Brad that he's still a great GM, like a consistent top 10 GM, as Kyle is a reformed Goody hater.
Reforming.
So you're not fully reforming.
Reforming, ing.
You still need to see more.
Yes.
Point taken. We're going to get to that in 2 minutes. But I want you to tell us about Underdog Fantasy, and I also want to get to next after he does. You laid out, Brad, the way that these teams get built. I want to know what Goody has to do next. Like, what? Like we've gone through like the heart of free agency, and now we have a lot of time. You know, a month or month and a half leading up to the NFL draft. What is he going to prioritize, and what would you prioritize? 800-990-3776. Tell us about Underdog.
Oh, I can't wait to tell you about Underdog. I was talking to my brother last night. He said, man, Kyle, I tell you, I'm not going to lie. Since I downloaded that Underdog Fantasy app, watching sports has been so much more fun. These games mean so much more. And I said, brother, that is all it is about. And I want you to be just like me and just like my brother and download the Underdog Fantasy app because it will enhance your game watching experience. Here's how it works. You pick 2 to 5 players from at least 2 different teams, select higher or lower on those player stats, and if your pick hits, you can win up to 100 times. Your money. Yes, 100 times your money. It is so easy to play, so easy to download. Go to your app store and download the Underdog Fantasy app today or visit UnderdogFantasy.com and make sure you use promo code KBN. That's promo code KBN, and Underdog will match your first deposit up to $100. Yes, up to $100 that will match that, plus they'll give you a mystery pick to use on your first Pick'em entry. It is so fun to use. I want y'all to get in the game now. Download the Underdog Fantasy app and make sure you use promo code KBN, and they'll match your first deposit up to $100. And always remember, must be 18 plus and present in the state where Underdog Fantasy operates. Terms do apply. Concerned with your play, call 1-800-GAMBLER or visit ncpgambling.org.
What do you want Goody to prioritize next in building out this roster? 800-990-3776. Back in 2 minutes.
Don't be hating.
True Chicago-style pizza is thin, crispy, and cut into squares. And thanks to Connie's Frozen Pizza, you can enjoy a true slice of the city. You'll enjoy it so much you won't even mind where it comes from. Connie's Frozen Pizzas are made from the same cornmeal crust Connie's has been serving for over 60 years. They're perfectly cheesy, perfectly saucy, and they're exactly what you crave. Get to know the true Chicago style with Connie's Frozen Pizza. Born in Chicago, loved by cheeseheads. Available in a freezer aisle near you.
Getting up to 5% back is easy at Fleet Farm. Fleet Rewards members can earn up to 5% back on every purchase, in-store and online. The earnings stack up automatically. The more you buy, the more you earn. No rebates, no coupons, no hassles. And Fleet Rewards membership is easy, so sign up now and start earning up to 5% back on everything you need for everyday life at Fleet Farm. Some exclusions apply.
It's time for the Milwaukee Basketball Report on 94.5 ESPN. Brought to you by National Liquor Mart, located at 16th and National in Milwaukee. National Liquor Mart is packed with deals for all your beverage needs, where your satisfaction is their plan of action. Open 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. daily.
The Bucks fall to the Kings for the first time in over 8 years on Tuesday night.
Aaron Fox takes it to the left side. Now drives in on Lillard, puts up a floater off the window and good with a half a second to spare. On the inbound pass, it was deflected out of bounds, and Sacramento will finish out the first half the way they started it, scoring with impunity.
And that would really be the story of the whole game as the Kings go on to win 129-94. The Bucks unable to crack 30 points in the quarter. That means it was a 1-3 West Coast trip for the Bucks. Luckily, they're back at home to take on the 76ers on Thursday night. That one, 7 o'clock tip-off.
This has been the Milwaukee Basketball Report on 94.5 ESPN. Brought to you by National Liquor Mart.
Hey, this is Brad Nortman from KBN. Tune in to Kyle, Brust, and Nortman every day from 2 to 5. WKTI and WKTI HD Milwaukee.
A locally owned Good Karma brand station.
Broadcasting live from the Gruber Law Office's One Call That's All studio at the Avenue in downtown Milwaukee. This is Kyle, Brust, and Nortman, KBN, on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
I've written down the 3 to 4 position groups I'd like to be focusing on in the draft and even at the end of free agency here in picking up, not the end of free agency, but in terms of what he should be prioritizing and need. And when I say he, I mean Goody, because that's what we're having a conversation on, the general manager of the Green Bay Packers, who I believe has set the team up in a good position, eating the cap hit of Aaron Rodgers last year, cutting bait from David Bakhtiari, Devondre Campbell, giving us an opportunity to have these conversations, which are typically like draft, 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 draft. But now you can say, all right, well, with free agency, he did this. With free agency, he got an all-pro safety. All right, we don't have to focus as much on safety. Where else can we focus on? What do you guys think?
Well, to me, as I look at it, he has the, you know, Goody has the rest of free agency and the draft in order to fill up the holes. And because he was signed a running back in Josh Jacobs, because he signed Xavier McKinney, your dog safety, he's starting to like cross out those needs. So he's going to have more flexibility in the draft, which I like. Packers like drafting best available. And honestly, when you draft best available and you feel conviction, you're going to find a place for him. But to me, there's two things that I still need to see progress in. Linebacker and the other safety. Currently, as I look at the Packers depth chart, they are so incredibly light in linebacker. I mean, you only got Quay Walker, Isaiah McDuffie, and honestly, some dude I've never heard of before. and the other safety position is still pretty much wide open. I would like to have most of the starters set before the draft. So if Goody can start to look at linebacker position, even if it's a vet, even if it's a savvy, reliable, run-stopping vet as linebacker to fill up the starting role and one more safety to be able to say, you know what, this guy can start. A starting linebacker and a starting safety. Doesn't have to be splashy. Linebacker and safety. If we can do those before the draft, I feel like Goody is completely equipped to fill his spots as he sees fits.
See, here's the thing. When it comes to what you need, it's pretty clear and obvious. And then one thing I will applaud Goody for is the fact that everybody saw it, right? Everybody saw what the need was. You needed a safety. You need that. And so the fact that he addressed that, I applaud him for actually not ignoring a big gaping hole on this team. So the next thing that obviously needs to be addressed is, you said it, Brad, you need to address the linebacker position. Now, you went through all the notes of why they need to do it, but I'm going to tell you right now who they need to get. They need to get a veteran that can come in and bring leadership on this defense, because that linebacker position is in a transition year, and you have a young guy in Quay Walker that has not reached his potential yet, and everybody still wants him to pop. They're looking for him to develop. You have a guy like Isaiah McNuffie that you acknowledged before, who is still a young, trending guy that looks like he has the potential to be a starter in NFL. Not elite, but he can play. He can give you reps. He can give you snaps. So in order to help that transition, to solidify this defense, to bring some type of veteran presence and leadership, the Packers must go out there and they have to sign somebody that can be exactly that. And that's why they got to go out there and get a guy like Bobby Wagner. Bobby Wagner brings you everything that this team needs. If you need a veteran presence, he brings that. If you want to bring somebody that's won a championship, he brings that. If you want to bring somebody in that can mentor and teach and show Quay Walker the way and help Quay become the potential Quay to the guy that's delivering every single Sunday, every single game day for you, you have to go get a guy like that. He still has something left in the tank. He had a phenomenal season last year, and the Packers need to make another splash, but this splash is about leadership and getting a championship-driven person and a championship piece in Bobby Wagner. But that's what you need. You need a linebacker that can contribute to this team and elevate that defense to be the real deal.
Yeah, and I think what's been interesting about these signings that Goody's made in free agency, Josh Jacobs is, I mean, simply put, you can move on from him after one season. The Xavier McKinney deal, it's basically 2 years that you are guaranteeing yourself to have him, and with flexibility to potentially restructure on the back end of that contract. And so what you're seeing is Goody's really focusing on not making himself like he's getting guys, but he's also leaving himself some flexibility to not get stuck in the same situation that he has been with some of these guys. Like, maybe he overspent on Devondre Campbell, a guy that had one good season after being on the practice squad of the Falcons, and then he had a great season, all pro, and really was never the same guy after one season of really just getting a lot of tackles, in my opinion. But with that, right, I'm focusing on linebacker, obviously. But I think one that is being overlooked, and it's boring, it's completely boring, the defensive tackle position. Kenny Clark and Devontae Wyatt are those guys right now that would likely be the starters. I know we like your guy, Carl Brooks, Kyle. But again, depth at the line. They need depth. You can't just have, like, right now, it would probably be Preston, Rashawn, Kenny Clark, Devontae Wyatt is the main, you know, four guys. But they don't have depth, and Devontae Wyatt is not a consistent defensive tackle yet. Rashawn Gary, God bless his soul, I love the three sack games, but there's not as much consistency there. And Preston Smith is consistent, but he's not 27 going to be able to play a ton of snaps.
The oldest guy on the roster, right?
31 years old.
Wow.
We'll definitely get to the age part of this component as well. So I think it's boring. But I want linebacker, I want defensive tackle, and I want another offensive lineman. I want to build for the future in that position, not in the first round, but do what they've done. Use one of those two third-round picks on a guy that you think you can develop into it being a good Green Bay offensive lineman. So I'm focusing boring now, because you have the skill position players on offense figured out. I mean, you brought in a running back. You believe in the wide receivers and tight ends. You believe in your quarterback. So get some depth on the offensive line and then focus on defense.
Well, and defensive line is extra critical this year, because obviously the scheme is moving to four linemen. So inevitably you're going to have more need there because you have more defensive linemen on the field. Plus, it's the position group that rotates the most.
Mm-hmm.
They always are rotating defensive line. Very rarely do you have a guy play 100% of the snaps. So they are rotating, therefore you need
I want a third down package.
Hey,
you know what I mean? I want the NASCAR package that the Giants had. I'm not saying we're going to have that this year, but like in a 4-3,
You have four guys that are down now. There's going to be no mistake with Matt LaFleur talking to reporters about having two down linemen ever again. Gene in Sun Prairie, 800-990-3776. What are you prioritizing here for the Green Bay Packers?
Well, I think it's always smart to take big men who fight in the trenches.
Yeah,
if we could get an offensive lineman in the draft, but no one on the draft mock-ups that I've seen thinks that at 25 there'll be any good offensive lineman left. So I think maybe we'll kiss that goodbye. But Cooper DeJean is someone from Iowa who interests me. He seems to be defensive back, but whether he could substitute as safety sometimes, he's getting a lot of good press for the Packers. But, you know, an issue that I wish you guys might be able to research a little bit more would be how agents churn people's contracts to make money. Because I really wonder if Aaron Jones got bad advice from his agent.
Oh, it's a great question, Gene.
Yeah, you know, and I think I was listening to some of the pundits on The Athletic the other day talk about, you know, there's a built incentive for agents to move people around because they get fees every time. And, you know, the Packers were offering a little less than the Vikings, but Jones might have been able to get close to what the Vikings are giving him and be able to stay. So I really would like to see somebody do a little bit more in-depth reporting on what's going on with some of these contracts.
Thank you for the call, Gene. Love your input and love your question there, because it's something that when I subbed on Jen, Gabe, and Chewy, I was with Jen Latta, and we were talking a lot about how when conversations with Aaron Jones and Brian Gutekunst were going on, this was on Friday, and it seems like talks came to a close. And when I say close, not like close, done deal. Like, this is our final offer, and reports were that they were asking him to take a 50% pay cut. Kyle, I think you have mentioned you saw someone say that it was potentially 1 year, $4 million with $2 million in incentives. Mm-hmm. And he ultimately signs for 1 year, $6 million with $1 million incentives to get to that seven number that he got with the Vikings. What is interesting, what I want to ask Brad here is, did Aaron Jones' agent, who is a bigger known agent, you know, Drew Rosenhaus is his name. If you've been around sports, you've probably heard his name in conversations. Did Rosenhaus just, you know, think that in the open market, Jones was going to get better than what he did? And the running back market took off in on Monday. Like, it was just like boom, 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 boom. And next thing you know, Jones is like, I got to get somewhere now.
Yeah, and to answer this question, you really have to dive into the head of an agent. So how are agents compensated in the NFL, right? So this is collectively bargained so that they have a range by which they can get paid. It's as little as 1% and as much as 3% of the player's cash earnings, right? So whatever they get paid, not like what their cap number is, anything. Literally what you make in any given year, you take that times 3%, which is pretty standard. Not many agents go below the 3%. They all just give you the pitch of, hey, 3%, I'm going to give you my max attention, my max effort. And that's kind of the standard that's been set. So most agents, because of that, they want to get you as much money as you can right now, and they're less concerned about longevity. They're more focused on this year. What can I do to maximize your dollars this year? Because that maximizes my dollars this year. And then we'll figure out next year when it gets there. That's kind of their focus. And they're willing to sacrifice. Agents might be able to push you to, like, hey, let's get more dollars today, and we'll figure it out down the road. Less focus on longevity.
Like a real estate agent.
Yeah, so it's transactional, right? I mean, if they can get you a guaranteed long contract, well, that's great, right? That's creating an income stream. But because even Josh Jacobs' contract, Xavier McKinney's contract, those are all like very front-loaded and guaranteed money. Mm-hmm. They start to see where, like, the back end of these contracts, they're not guaranteed. They can be restructured, all these things. So they really focus on how can I get you as much money right now, because that means more money for me right now. We have no idea what the future looks like.
And to follow up on Gene's question about the Aaron Jones thing and the contract thing, one other thing I'd like to add is there has to be a personal competitive component of this, right? I took two pay cuts. I love the Green Bay Packers. Like, Aaron Jones with his agent probably just got to a point where they were both getting frustrated. Rosenhaus for wanting to get what's best for his client, and Aaron Jones feeling not as valued as, especially after the last five games that he showed out for the Packers. It's one of those things where you always overvalue yourself, but you think your value is more when you look at it on paper, which sometimes you have to do, and you have to take out the leadership component and about production, it's going to be,
I think, you know, Goody's going with, I think Josh Jacobs will give me more production for the dollar I'm paying him, for the amount of carries we'll be able to give him. If he stays healthy, which, again, Jacobs has a little bit of an injury history, too, of here and there, dinks and dunks, but he can carry a workload. So yeah, they definitely have to find a second back, too.
No, they have to. But you know, I respect Aaron Jones so much, immensely. And we're going to miss his intangibles. But at the end of the day, Jones left over respect and not about money. You know what I'm saying? Like, he left over the fact that he felt disrespected by the Green Bay Packers and the organization to keep asking him to, you know, to do this and do that for the organization. At what point, is the organization going to do right by me? But as Brad just said, it ain't really so much about doing right by you, whether it's the agent or the team. So
800-990-3776. Chef Ed chimes in. The best part of his day is always 2 to 5. We love you, Chef Ed. Rob in the 262. Wow, Ben, that Goody Rogers playoff take was calm, cool, and collective and spot on. Kind of wondering if you're feeling okay. I don't know if I am. I must be sick, Rob. 800-990-3776. Brad, tell us about a great growing brand, Carbliss.
I would love to tell you about Carbliss. I've told you about how delicious Carbliss is, which it is, because they got the fruit flavors. They got the classic cocktails that I've been loving lately. The flavor is unlike anything else you've tasted. And I've also already told you about how well it fits into my diet, because I'm an active guy. I eat healthy. I don't want to detonate everything I do when I just want to be able to relax a little bit and have an alcoholic beverage. So we know that it's 100 calories per can, no carbs, no sugars, and less carbonation and gluten-free. But here's something I want to tell you about. Hot off the presses right here, the Wisconsin Business Journal did a study, and they found that Carbliss was named the fastest growing private company in the Midwest, and they called it a, quote, runaway winner. Guys, if you haven't tried it at this point, the secret is out. That is powerful. Carbliss is taking the Midwest. It's taking the country by storm. It's taking my taste buds and my heart by storm. It's time that you try it if you haven't already. Because honestly, it's coming to a supermarket and a bar near you. So I want you to find out why Liss is more and find them online and at retailers near you. Carbliss, baby.
Goody needs to be all in, according to Kyle. We hear from him again next on Kyle, Brust, and Nortman.
You're listening to Kyle, Brust, and Nortman, KBN.
Craig Council bobblehead that was given away, and we, just did a nice, soliloquy? Is that the right word?
Yeah, like a montage?
Like a Virgil.
Vigil?
Vigil.
Vigil.
A vigil. We did a vigil.
Vigil.
On ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
Eastbound 94 still seeing a little bit of a backup from 84th Street past the stadium interchange. Westbound side is tight just at the stadium. We've also got a little bit of a backup along southbound 41 as you're making your way past Hampton Avenue. By the time you hit Capitol Drive, you are good to go all the way down to the Zoo interchange. And check out the TMJ4 Storm Team forecast. Today, early sunshine, increasing clouds, slight chance for an afternoon shower. High 53 at the lakefront, 63 inland. Tonight, chance of showers, isolated thunderstorms are possible with a low of 40. From the WTMJ Traffic Center, I'm Debbie Lazaga on 94.5 ESPN.
Even when you think you know what's going on.
And I call him Bird. But he's responding to it, which is a much better name.
You can't say that.
You can never be too sure.
I thought you could. You told me you can say the S word, but the F word.
No.
Packers, nonsense, chaos.
At not zero true. Points have I ever told you that.
That is not true.
Jen, Gabe, and Chewy, morning 7 to 9 on 94.5 ESPN and available wherever you get your podcasts with Wisconsin On Demand.
Get 0% interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. I'm Gina Della from Pella. Pella's free in-home consultations make replacing or redesigning your windows and doors easy. We go beyond just measuring and handing you a quote by listening and educating you on all of your product options. And with Design Works, you can see what your home will look like before you buy. Order by March 31st to get 0% interest for up to 3 years. Set your free consultation at PellaWI.com.
Certain restrictions apply.
ESPN Wisconsin's Mark Tauscher here, and there is one thing I think everyone can agree on. Potholes stink. And this year's weather will make it one of the worst years yet. Well, Johnson & Sons Paving is ready to take on the challenge with a team that has over two decades of experience. When the potholes pop up in your asphalt, Johnson & Sons Paving can patch or replace the whole area. Book an appointment now at johnsonandsonspaving.com. Get that appointment booked before May 31st, and you might even see Old T on the job site for a visit. Find full contest details at ESPNWisconsinContest.com.
Make it a real Mad March with a playoff payout at Pottawatomie. Every week, you could score your share of 100 grand in cash and free play. Play this March for drawing entries. Win each Thursday. Plus, the prizes refresh every week for even more winners. The playoff payout at Pottawatomie, Milwaukee. It's anyone's game. For more details, visit paysbig.com/payout. Must be 21 and a club member to play.
UW Credit Union presents the Student Athlete of the Week, supporting local student athletes as they grow on the field, in the classroom, and in the community. UW Credit Union is here for every you. Learn more at uwcu.org. Here's Ashton Rotman with a UW Credit Union Student Athlete of the Week.
This week's UW Credit Union Student Athlete of the Week goes to Marquette High's Nolan Minasalli. The senior Hilltoppers basketball player, a big part of why they are heading to state this season. In the team's 64-58 win over West Allis Central last weekend, Minasalli added 17 points, including a pair of pivotal free throws late to extend Marquette's lead. On the season, and including the playoffs, the 6'5 senior averaged 21.8 points per game, including 6 30-plus point performances. The third-seeded Hilltoppers will take on two-seed Kettle Moraine on Friday night in state semifinal action, that one happening at the Kohl Center. Minasalli will continue his hoops career at Division I St. Thomas in Minnesota next season.
This is Kyle Brustin Nortman, KBN, on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
800-990-3776. Dave from Aaron chimes in. Jason scoffed at my take poking around the Saints to see if they could pick up Williams on a good deal to compliment Jacobs. I'm not going to scoff like you say that Jason did, but I will say too similar of a style. They need more of a third down back, pass block, come out the backfield, catch passes. That's probably what you're looking for. And that's what's interesting, because if you're looking for that type of running back, it's hard to throw a rookie into the system and be like, hey, we need you to do all these intangible things and do it at a high level for this team.
Yeah, I mean, here's the thing. I'm kind of past the whole not expecting. I think that's the Green Bay Packers way, right? Not expecting running back to be impactful right away. I feel like that's one of the things that we don't expect. I feel like we need to change that. We need to shift that. This is what we should expect. We should expect them to draft somebody who needs to contribute. I don't want them just drafting three guys and we'll see which one. No, draft somebody that you have trust in that can. Listen, I understand pass blocking is a very hard thing to do in the NFL, but have the other intangibles and the weapons to be able to catch the ball at the backfield. Be a change of pace back. We all know what this team needs. Ben ain't play football, but he knows what the team needs. I ain't play at a high level whatsoever. I play like everybody else in high school. I know what we need, and you, Brad, you played at a high level. Everybody knows what this team needs, and they need to go get it.
Well, and you're exactly right about the running back part, right? Because, first of all, if they do draft a running back, I think you can have an expectation for him to play the utmost of their role, because it's going to be a minimized role. Josh Jacobs is going to be your dude.
And that's a good thing, right? Defining roles to maximize what you just need to do when you're out there.
Exactly. And it's going to be a little bit of speed burst on third down. It's going to be maybe some pass catching. And it's going to be the ability to block. And he's only going to have to, you know, maybe get 8 touches a game and try to maximize those. So it's a good thing that you got a guy you can so rely on, and also draft a guy and expect to say, hey, okay, kiddo, get on there and go do your thing. Because if they draft a running back, these guys are ready, right? I mean, we've seen so many guys, first or second year running backs, come in, make a difference, and make an impact. So there's no reason to expect that the Packers can't land a guy like that.
And it's time for Goody to be all in. Like, it's time for Goody to basically make sure that this year, this is a win now mode for Goody. He has to approach 2024 like this. And I'm going to say this, 2024 is a leap year. not just for the calendar, but also for the Green Bay Packers. You got a lot of guys that need to take that leap in year two. And when I say in year two, Jordan Love is in what? Year two as a starter. You're talking about all the rookies that we have, year two. When you're talking about Rashid Walker at left tackle, what is that? Year two. We have a lot of guys who need to take that leap in their second year. So the Green Bay Packers need to recognize, if the trend goes in the direction that most players go, like, we do not expect for Jaden Reed to come back and have a sophomore slump. We expect him to ascend. We expect him to trend in the right direction. That's what we want to see. That's what we need to see. That's what we expect to see. As a general manager, as a coach, you need to recognize that we have a lot of young, talented guys that are all going to come of age at the same time and all need to be paid at the same time. Goody needs to recognize that everybody ain't going to get paid. So this is the time right now, as the young guys are starting to get ready to go into a time where they're going to be playing at a very high level, going to be contributing and having confidence in contributing. Goody must play for winning now. So signing Josh Jacobs, signing Xavier McKinney, they're great things, but there are other moves that need to be made in order for us to capitalize on this moment. I do not want Goody to be playing a long game thinking about 2026. He needs to be thinking about 2024, 2025, and 2026, because this is our window of opportunity and we must seize the day.
Are you with Kyle? 800-990-3776. Because that word all in means a lot to a lot of different people, right? Does it mean, like, all in for the Packers doesn't mean what it means for a lot of teams. Because all in for Goody means I'm going to take some cap hits, but I don't want to mess up like and have like a losing season where we're just not relevant in the NFC North. Like, it's not the Los Angeles Rams style of, like, we went all in, we won a Super Bowl, and they're trying to find their way back with Matt Stafford and drafting Puka Nacua and Kyron Williams, right? They did a great job with that, but that's not always guaranteed. You don't always see teams go all in and then come back 3 years later and find their way in the conversation of being a good team looking to fight for another championship.
That's a great point, Ben, because I think you're right, Kyle. I think this is the time for Goody to go all in. What we're witnessing is the Packers going all in. I mean, it'll never be an all-out onslaught where they borrow from the future to win this season. I think what they're doing right now, which is, you know, being aggressive in free agency and, you know, tilting things in their favor this year, but they're never going to mortgage the future completely in order to do that. Is this version of Green Bay Packers going all in, is that enough for you to be satisfied?
Listen, this is not enough for me to be satisfied, because here's the thing, is that you have guys that don't need to be signed into another three some odd years. Invest the money that you have available right now when you have some young talent in trying to build a championship team. We just talked about what the biggest needs are. Ben talked about D-line and running back. You talked about linebacker. I talked about linebacker. We filled a little void at safety. We have to fill all those voids with impact players. Don't give me a Jonathan Owens. Don't give me somebody that can just come in and play a role. I don't want those guys. I want guys that can make a contribution to a championship team, because I'm telling you, this window that you have of opportunity come 2026, there are going to be guys that have to walk. Why? Because you can't pay everybody, and you don't know if you're going to be able to draft the replacement. So when you have the goods on your team, you need to add ammo, and you need to make sure that you explode when you have the opportunity, and now is the time.
Ray in the 414 with an interesting point. Go all in for 2025. Give Halfley, the new defensive coordinator, a one-year time frame to get the defense on the same page and sort out all the new additions and get settled in. 2025, all in. So part of me is like, you know, I agree that 2024 could be a good year to continue to grow and 2025 be like that year. But at the same time, I actually don't know if I like it, because you don't want to waste the opportunity. Like, if somebody pops this year, right, if one of the tight ends pops or the wide receivers pops, you're gonna need to pay those guys. And again, I don't want to use the Halfley's a defensive coordinator's first year as an excuse to not go get it done. I believe Pettine's first year was 19.
I think that's right.
And they were a solid defense in 19, helping them get to the NFC Championship game. They were horrible from a run defense standpoint, but they had a great pass rush, and they created a lot of turnovers because of that pressure. So whatever Halfley's defense is, and from a 4-3 standpoint, everything he's looking for, I don't want to look at it as, like, go all in 2025. I don't want to waste the opportunity
any year that you actually feel like you're a threat to go all the way. And I think this team probably feels like they are after they went on the road and slaughtered the Cowboys and was neck and neck with the Super Bowl contending 49ers.
Well, there's two forces you're going to be fighting with after 2025, right? All these young receivers and tight ends and offensive linemen that are starting right now, they're all going to want to get paid after that season. So I don't want to just put all of that pressure on one season. Let's spread that out and focus on 2024 and 2025, maybe even 2026. The other thing is Jordan Love's going to get paid. He's going to get paid. He's going to get paid $50 million or more. How those contracts are structured is that the middle and the end of it are more restrictive. They're more painful for a salary cap than the first year or two. So this year, 2025, maybe a little bit next year, it's not going to be a $50 million cap hit. It's going to be like 20 and then 35, and then it's going to be like 60, 60, 60, something like that. So these first couple years, you will be able to get a bit of a, quote, discount on Jordan Love's, hopefully, high-level quarterback play.
Got to tell you about Bucks Plus, because there's a lot of stuff going on with Bucks Plus, and it's amazing. Got a Thanalysis event going on at Pottawatomie coming up with Giannis, his brother, tweeting that he's, you know, going to be present. That's pretty sweet. Your eyes emoji. I like the eyes emoji. When Giannis does the eyes emoji supporting his brother in a Thanalysis show, I love that. But also know that from the biggest plays on the court to the comments in the locker room after, especially like on a night like yesterday, I was tired. I did a double shift. Did Jen, Gabe, and Chewy, Kyle, Bruston, Ortman. I couldn't stay up for the Kings and Bucks game, and it was kind of a blowout. But what I can do is catch up with the Bucks and Six, because it's on the Bucks Plus audio network. And if you missed any of the game or just want to relive the moments, well, it's there for you with game recaps every morning after. Hear the high-flying dunks from Giannis, deep threes from Dame. Need more of those yesterday. And catch the comments post-game about what happened on the court with Bucks in six. On the Bucks Plus audio network, find it at bucks.com/plus or on Spotify, Apple, or wherever you get your podcasts. It's Wednesday, so we hear from the punter, Brad Nortman. Hear Brad out next.
This is Kyle Bruston Nortman.
So they are lucky. Those other teams, whether it's Kentucky or whether it's Oregon or was it TCU?
That was TCU.
TCU, they're lucky I didn't play in that game. You got upset by a bad team, TCU.
On ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
Please continue around the Marquette interchange with the president in town. That's gumming up the works. Everybody's got to slow down until everything gets rolled through. So just be extra careful as you're heading through. Southbound 43 delays from Capitol Drive all the way down through the Marquette and over the high rise. Northbound's pretty backed up as well, making your way into the Marquette. We've also got eastbound 94 slowing down from Holly Road, pretty much solid all the way to about 35th Street, then right in the Marquette interchange as well. Traffic is brought to you by James Imaging Systems, your local document imaging partner. Visit jamesimaging.com. And check in the TMJ4 Storm Team forecast. Tonight, chance for showers and isolated thunderstorms with a low of 40. Tomorrow, rain showers are likely with an isolated thunderstorm with a high of 45. Weather is brought to you by Higher Love Cannabis Company. Find your Higher Love today only 59 miles from Green Bay. Find higherlove.com/CBD. From the WTMJ Traffic Center, I'm Debbie Lozaga, 94.5 ESPN.
There's only one store that gives you every possible choice in diamonds.
Welcome to Kessler's.
Gabe Nigel here. I know you've already heard me talking about how Mentality has helped me over the years, but there are others like me. Jason has been using Mentality for a while now and is loving the results.
I have gotten a handful of friends, probably a couple dozen, especially those that are closer to my age, maybe even a little bit older, because I just tell them, you got to check this out. Do not wait any longer. Just go and admit it. Yep, you're at an age where things are slowing down. I promise you, you're not going to regret it, and that's truly what I get. I'll get a phone call after, like, man, I feel like a kid at Chuck E. Cheese right now.
Learn more today at MotiUSA.com.
There are any number of reasons you might consider selling your home. To move closer to family, live within a smaller budget, or just wanting a change of scenery. Whatever your reasons, having to figure out all the various housing market trends in your area may not be what you signed up for. That's where an agent who is a Realtor comes in. Realtors have the expertise to help you find the right price and navigate the process to sell your home in a way that's right for you. That's who we are. Realtors are members of the National Association of Realtors.
Don't you love an extra $100 in your pocket? Have a TurboTax expert file your taxes for you by March 31st to get $100 back instantly. Because no matter what moves you made last year, TurboTax makes them count. That means getting $100 back and 100% accurate taxes only from Intuit TurboTax. Must file by 3/31. Credit only applicable to federal filing fees with TurboTax Full Service. Offer can be modified or terminated at any time.
Go beyond your field of study and get a world-class education in leadership by joining the U.S. Army ROTC. Army ROTC programs transform students into confident leaders and provide a wide range of scholarships to help pursue life-defining careers. As an Army officer, you'll work side-by-side with peers who support your growth. Gain the experience and get the resources to open doors down the road. Army ROTC is open for enrollment. Visit goarmy.com/ROTC to learn more about available opportunities and scholarships, including at Marquette University.
Are you tired of looking at a dirty, dusty, and cracked garage and looking for a fresh new look? Hi, this is ESPN Milwaukee's Jen Ladd, and I'm here to tell you about Floor Shield by Showtime Floors. Using a state-of-the-art coating 4 times stronger than traditional epoxy, it's tough enough to be used in military bases and airports. Floor Shield is certified as an anti-slip floor and also eco-friendly, all while being UV stable, and my favorite part, easy to clean. This makes it perfect for outdoor spaces, just like your patio. Check it out at ShowtimeFloors.com and work with a specialist to transform your space in as little as 1 day.
Do you worry about how much someone drinks?
Do you feel neglected or unloved? If you answered yes to any of these questions, you are not alone.
Al-Anon and Alateen can help.
Call 1-866-200-0223 or visit alanon.org/help.
You're listening to Kyle Brust and Nortman, KBN, on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
Basketball tournament season is finally here, and make sure you enhance your game watching experience by playing the Underdog Fantasy Sports app. I'm telling you, it is so fun. This is how you play. First thing you got to do, you got to take out your cell phone. You have to download the Underdog Fantasy app right now, or you can visit underdogfantasy.com and you can play along with all the great games. Next, what you need to do is you need to remember this. Write it down. KBN, yes, KBN, that is the promo code you get to use. And when you use the promo code KBN, when you deposit your money, they will match it up to $100. If you put in $100, they will give you $100, and that means you have $200 to have fun with. And here's how the game works. You pick between two to five players from at least two different teams. Select higher or lower on those player stats. If your picks hit, you can win up to 100 times your money. Make this season so much fun by watching and playing the Underdog Fantasy app today. And make sure you use promo code KB, and I'm telling you, you will not regret it. And you must be 18 plus and present in the state where Underdog Fantasy operates. Terms do apply. Concerned with your play, call 1-800-GAMBLER or visit ncpgambling.org. Get in the game today with Underdog Fantasy.
We do this every Wednesday. We hear from our guy, Brad Nortman, our punter, and hear Brad out.
They say punters are people, too.
Punters are worthy of breaking news.
No, really, that's what they say.
Raising awareness everywhere that punters are people, too.
Okay, let's go to it. Time to hear from the punter. Time to hear Brad out.
This is Kyle Brust and Nortman across ESPN Wisconsin. Ben Brust here alongside Kyle Wallace, Chris Larson running the show, and I turn it over to Brad, and I'm going to do my best to shut up and listen.
Thank you for the floor, gentlemen. Now, guys, here's something I want to talk about this week. There should be rules for what parents can name their kids. Plainly speaking, you can name your kid anything you want in the world. It doesn't matter what it is. It doesn't matter if it's hilarious, if it's inappropriate. You can literally name your kid anything. There is no restriction on it. There should be some restrictions. I don't know if it's you have to maybe get the doctor and the nurse and one family member together and you submit the name to them and they say, okay, yeah, no, this is fine, but there needs to be some oversight with it. And I took the liberty of going down and finding real names. These are real names, guys, and this proves my point that
they better be bad names.
Oh, they're bad. That there needs to be some oversight with this. Let's start with sports, and then I'm going to go to real people. Like, so they're all real people, but sports and the normal people. Sports. Dick Butkus. Coco Crisp. Haha, Clinton Dix, Harry Colin, Dick Trickle, Kool-Aid McKinstry, I think that's right, Will Clapp, Derealist Clark, DeColdis Crawford, General Booty, Steel Johnson, and Rowdy Beers. Like, those sports names and real people. Those names are absurd. It gets better when you open it up to the real world. Now, buckle up for this one.
I don't know. I
I can't wait to respond to this.
How about the name Penis? That's spelled like Dennis, but with a P.
Hey!
Somebody named their kid
I think I have a penis.
Somebody named their kid Lasagna. There's a lasagna walking around out there, and it was because of the cravings during pregnancy. Ridiculous.
Lasagna?
Lasagna. Somebody named their kid Batman. How about this one? A girl's name. Paige Turner. There's somebody named Vanderson Anderson. How about this one? Macon Bacon. It's just unfair for these kids. There's Pervert King. There's Jed.
Excuse me?
Pervert King. Real name.
Pervert King? Wow.
Yes. Last name King, first name Pervert.
That's the only one I'm drawing the line on right now.
Okay.
Let's get nuts!
There's Jed I. Knight.
That's great.
That's a real name. There's somebody named Jurassic Park. There's somebody named Bud Light. There's somebody named Alma Knack. And there's somebody named Bear Trap. My favorite one. This is my favorite one of all of them. You ready? Marijuana Pepsi Jackson.
Hey, she worked at UW Whitewater. Don't
she
you
did?
Tell? Yeah, she was a counselor. She was a counselor there at UW Whitewater.
To her credit, she became very, very like acclaimed, and she became like a PhD. She's a stud. But her name's Marijuana Pepsi Jackson.
Yeah, I mean, she talked about it. Her parents was on Marijuana Pepsi and whatever.
This proves my
point. Whatever else is going on, name her Marijuana Pepsi Jackson.
I rest my case by saying life is hard enough already. This is ridiculous to be able to deal with this as your namesake.
The only reason why this is a really good Hear Brad Out is because you are on the wrong side of history here. That is the worst take of all time. Can you go through the sports ones again? And even when you're going through all these, are great.
No, well,
like it's
you
fun.
Want to be named
it's
lasagna?
Fun. I didn't say lasagna.
You want to be named Pervert?
These
are the sports ones.
Yeah.
Okay, let's go back to the sports ones.
Will Clapp?
Okay.
I mean, that's hilarious.
To be fair, I focused on like the real people and then I went to sports. The sports ones aren't bad. Dick Butkus.
That's great.
Coco Crisp.
That's awesome.
Haha, Clinton Dix. Haha.
So the issue with this is that some of these aren't their names. Haha, Clinton Dix, that's not his real name. It's Haseen, or so I believe it is.
Yeah.
That's not his real name.
Okay, well, you know Duck Buckus is. Harry Colon is.
Yeah.
You can't grow hair on a
Will
colon,
Clapp.
So what's the problem
Will
with that?
Will Clapp, that might
Steel
be.
Johnson?
Will Clapp is my favorite.
I don't know Steel Johnson. And then what's called the real name, too? Kool-Aid McKinstry, or whatever it is. That ain't his real name.
Yeah, and keep going, because there was one of them where I'll
Dick
stop him.
No, that
Great race car driver.
Harry Colon, yeah, he is. General Booty. That's a real one.
General Booty, I like that one.
Dakota Crawford.
That's a good one,
too. That's a great name!
That's,
I would love to be named
Dakota. Those are actually pretty cool. Steel Johnson. Rowdy Beers. Will Clapp.
Will Clapp what? Never know.
Will Clapp. Rowdy Beers.
Better
Steel
than
Johnson,
Brad.
Dick Trickle. Nah, man. Brad's awesome.
Brad?
Brad's awesome.
Yeah,
Brad and Chad?
I'd rather be Brad Norton than Steel Johnson.
I will say,
I'd rather be Steel Johnson than Brad Norton.
You want to be named, Jurassic Park?
No, I will say this. This show is full of plain Jane names with Bradley, Kyle, and Benjamin. These are some basic names that we
have. And Chris.
Here. Christopher.
It's just plain.
Yeah, plain. Nothing outside of the box here with our parents and their name choice. But I agree. These names are they're unique. I'm actually with you, Brad. I'm against stupid names. Like Elon Musk named his son like some weird symbol. This is stupid. This is really stupid because you have to think about what your child has to go through. And you talked about Marijuana Pepsi Jackson, whatever her name was, who used to work at Whitewater. She became famous based off her name. I remember when I was in school, they did a whole like little thing about her and her name and her upbringing. That you know what she. I'm dead serious. I'm pretty sure her parents were on drugs. And so I mean,
I think that's true.
A lot of people, parents are making these decisions when they're not right.
Ray in the 414.
That's what he's saying. They shouldn't be doing it.
Yeah,
I agree with Brad. Limits.
Real G's move in silence like lasagna. Shout out Lil Wayne. I know the reference now.
Yeah. That's a good reference.
My cousin dated Richard Biter.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. Was that her real name?
Yeah, according to Santa Claus in the 920.
Quite the name. I don't know what the father was thinking.
Katrina 920, IndyCar driver Will Power.
Oh, that's pretty good. There was a real person. I forgot that on the
Stop saying there was a real person.
Well, they're real versus sports people.
What about Max Power?
Dill Pickle.
I got it off a hairdryer.
Max Power. Dill Pickle.
That was creative. Honestly, though, I'm with Brad because some of these made up names that people have nowadays, I don't like them.
Yeah.
I don't like these weird names that they just say, I'll just name my kid this. You're making stuff up.
It's just life's too hard already. And look, some of these names are sweet. Like Derealdis Clark is cool. Dakoldis Crawford. Dick Butkus is classic. I mean, there are some cool names on here, but taken as a whole,
you guys are both boring. Because their parents are naming their kids these names, it gives us enjoyment. I'm not thinking about the kid right now. I'm thinking about when I hear these names. I love unique names. I love when I hear them.
Unique, quote unquote, unique names on the list for Baby Brust.
Great question, Chris.
Baby Brust got a unique name too.
How?
Because I don't know. Some people don't know how to pronounce it.
It's a common name.
Some people don't know how to pronounce it.
It just speaks to your intelligence.
Some people don't know how to pronounce it. I've never met one before until now.
Chris chimes in the 414. I guess he's cool with me saying this. My last name is Payne, and people say I should name my kid Max or House. House of Max Payne.
Oh, that's pretty good, actually.
I'm with it, Chris. Time to get busy. Have a kid and name it after this conversation.
But think about that.
So you three are just no fun.
Yeah, I'm against stupid names.
You are putting a burden on your child, a burden that they don't deserve.
Chris Larson is the most basic name I've ever heard.
Christopher,
St. Christopher. I'm after a saint, pal. Get with it.
Roasted. That's Justin the 262. I don't know if I trust Big Daddy Bobo with this name.
What you about to say there?
I ain't saying this one, Bobo. I ain't saying this one. Ron makes a good point. For once again, all names are made up.
Yeah, but some have like insinuated meaning.
Some are just like, I'm gonna put this.
And yours is basic and boring, and theirs are unique and different.
That is true. That is true.
Brad out. Bad take by you guys.
Entertainment value, at least, with some of those names, right?
Josh and Hartland went to high school with a Michael Hawks, but everyone calls him Mike. Mm. Weird name, but he is two times the man I am.
I don't know what that means.
Mike Hawks?
I don't. What's wrong with that?
Oh, shorten it to Mike. Got it.
Yeah.
All right, moving on.
Yep.
I gotta think about it.
Yeah, you think about that basic Chris. But what's not basic is what Gina Della from Pella can do for
no.
you.
And if you're looking for something that, unlike these names, that's reliable, that's going to add value, it's Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Gina Della's name, that's a beautiful name. I love that name. And that's because Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin, what they can do for you, your home's value, your energy costs, the beauty of your home, it knocks it out of the park every time. That's because Pella Windows and Doors, they will revitalize the look of your home. It will increase your value and keep that energy cost down. I looked at the weather this coming week. Tomorrow, 40s and an inch of rain. Saturday, gale force winds. Now is the time to replace those windows and doors. You've been looking at them. You've been thinking about it. Now is the time to say, you know what? It's time that I replace my windows with Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin, because there's been no better time than to do it right now with 0% interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. That's right. You get your Pella now, get to pay later. For 3 years, in fact. No one else is offering 0% for up to 3 years. I promise you that. But you have to order by March 31st in order to get it. Set your free consultation today at PellaWI.com.
800-990-3776. I love these stories from all of you of KBN Nation. I guess, what's the most unique name that you know? Because if you have them, 800-990-3776. Because I love unique names. I'm not boring like Kyle, Brad, and Chris, just like their names are. We'll be back. Kyle, Brust, and Nortman.
You're listening to Kyle, Brust, and Nortman.
We've called him Whitey Tighties. We've called him the Hall Monitor. He's Jesse Nelson. Like, he's just, I'm Jesse Nelson. Kyle, you're Jesse Nelson.
On ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com. Football Guy.
Good morning, Tausch. How are you?
Football Guy.
Old T's a little, I'm not feeling 100%.
Coming at it from different views.
I think with all that little stuff going around and the long trip back from the loo, I'm going to grind.
Wildy and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Also sponsored by Coors Light. Weekdays 9 to noon on 94.5 ESPN. And available wherever you get your podcasts with Wisconsin On Demand.
And ESPN Radio Extra Point. with Evan Cohen, Chris Canty, and Michelle Smallman.
It's a 31-team league relative to comparisons. The Chiefs have to be left to the side. They just, like, they're better at everything than everyone, right? Sure. So I say that to ask this. Leaving the Chiefs aside, do the Ravens have the best offense in the NFL right now? Can you make that argument?
Yes, I can easily make that argument. But here's the thing. It might not just be the best offense. The Ravens might have the best roster in the NFL right now, top to bottom. I mean, think about it. Their defense is elite. It's the best defense in the league last year. Like, absolutely elite. Now, they lost a piece in Patrick Queen yesterday. That's going to hurt. But they still got Roquan Smith. They re-signed Justin Matabike, and they got a guy in Kyle Hamilton that's all pro player. So, I mean, they've got all of the elements that it takes in order to get back to the conference championship game. But again, they've got to build their roster to first win the AFC North, but then set their sights on the Kansas City Chiefs, because you know the Chiefs start the season in the conference championship game.
Been injured in an accident that wasn't your fault. We have legal professionals standing by to answer your questions. They'll tell you if you have a case and how much it's potentially worth. Call 800-420-6060. So if you've been injured in an accident and think you deserve compensation, call now. Find out if you have a case and how much it's potentially worth. Call 800-420-6060 to speak with a live person now. Advertisement sponsored by Legal Help Center may not be available in all states.
At Lowe's, pros save big every day when you buy in bulk. Save 10% when you buy 230 or more select James Hardie fiber cement siding panels. And there's more. Save 10% when you buy 9 or more select premium foam flooring underlayment. Visit us in-store or online for low prices on the materials you need. Because Lowe's knows savings. Lowe's knows pros. Selection varies by location. While supplies last, discount taken at time of purchase. See sales associate for details.
Get ready to paint the town green this St. Patrick's Day at Revere's Wells Street Tavern in Delafield. Join us for a weekend of fun starting Friday, March 15th with live music by the Old Goat Skipple Band and a Tullamore Dew sampling. On Saturday night, catch the firefighting bagpipers and the O'Brady's, followed by a Jameson sampling. Sunday morning, we're opening at 9 a.m. for Irish breakfast offerings and live music by Killarney Blarney, followed by the Trinity Irish Dancers. Enjoy specials like Reuben sandwiches and Guinness beef stew. Make Revere's Wells Street Tavern your St. Patrick's Day destination. Visit them at reverestavern.com.
Hey, Drew Scott here. And I'm Jonathan Scott, reminding you that life's better with a home policy from American Family Insurance. They can help you get just the right protection at just the right price and help you save when you bundle home and auto. Kind of like Goldilocks and the Three Bears. It'll be just right for you. We love a custom build. American Family Insurance. Insure carefully, dream fearlessly. Get a quote and find an agent at AmFam.com.
Products not available in every state. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
The moment you've been waiting for is here. Eagle Sports Range is officially open for action. It's Wisconsin's largest indoor range, offering unlimited range time and 40 lanes, which include 20 20-yard lanes and 20 50-yard lanes. And no reservations needed. Just show up and let the fun begin. With a staggering selection of 100 firearm rentals to use, every visit is a new adventure. Eagle Sports Range is also a go-to for education. Take advantage of their concealed carry classes and gun safety courses. Safety first, excitement second. Visit them out in Cudahy or online at EaglesportsRange.com. Eagle Sports Range, where education meets exhilaration.
You're listening to Kyle, Brust, and Nortman on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
Always a great time to join the Princeton Club, but just need a little bit of courage. That little bit of courage to get the tour, work with their team, and you'll see you have everything you need. From being open 24/7, having free childcare with your membership, it's amazing. I'm telling you. You have the cleanest health clubs in Wisconsin right here to better yourself and find your better tomorrow. 8 Madison locations, New Berlin, where I belong to. I'll be taking my daughter to the pool. Can't wait for that. Done some personal training, done a lot of the weights and cardio and workout classes. There's something for everyone for join the Princeton Club for a better tomorrow. And hear Brad out. We heard Brad say there needs to be restrictions on names. I think that if you have a unique name, you should just lean in and have fun with it. But I say that as a hypocrite because as Benjamin John Brust growing up, I was BJ Brust.
And how much did you like that?
Hey! In sixth grade, I decided to go by Ben.
Makes sense.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
Ned and Keel, 800-990-3776. What's the wildest name that you know?
You're not even going to believe this.
Okay,
it was
Ned.
Actually my neighbor, my brother's neighbor. His first name was Harry, not Harold, Harry. Middle initial was A, and his last name was Hole.
There's no way he went by that.
No, they had to put everything in his wife's name because of all the crank calls they would get.
That is amazing.
That's rich.
Thank you, Ned. 800-990-3776. 800-990-ESPN. Matt from Racine knew a guy in my old job. His name was Richard Ryder Jr. But I do want to get to a clip. Shout out to Jen Latta of ESPN. On Jen, Gabe, and Chewy. She sent this over. These are names from an Instagram post that they wanted to put on a baby list if they had no meaning that we don't know the definition of. So listen to the name. You might like the name, but also think of the association and try and get rid of it.
Think would be cute if they didn't have any meaning behind them. First, asthma.
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 Blinker.
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 Rosacea.
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 What's so good? This one is one of my favorites.
Calorie.
Calorie. 100%.
Do you hear it?
Calorie.
My name's Raby.
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 Feta.
I'd be naming my kid that right now.
If it weren't a cheese,
you know.
Feta.
You
know. Ooh. Felony.
Felony.
Might be my favorite.
Felony. These are not names, but you're giving people ideas.
I think it's funny to.
That was from John Christ, his Instagram, as he posted Calorie. I mean, Felony is a cute name.
It is.
I think Felony is so cute.
That's really good.
Felony Brust?
Yeah.
Felony Nortman?
It sounds like so like. Just like safe.
Yeah.
It ain't safe.
I was going to say, I don't want
felonies
that energy.
Ain't safe.
I don't say Felony Wallace. I don't want none of that energy for my babies.
Calorie?
That's so good.
Calorie was cute.
I thought Calorie was cute.
I like Feta. Feta. I like Feta. Feta's pretty good.
Come here, Feta.
Oh, man.
Feta's like a cat's name.
I could see that.
I don't know. I don't like cats, so.
Dan in the 608, I worked with a woman whose husband's name was Frank Wiener. I actually knew, I played with a Wiener
I'm sure you did. In fifth grade?
In middle school.
Yes, I'm sure you did.
No, Rolling Meadows High School.
Yeah.
Kyle Wiener was his name.
Oh, okay.
Good basketball player
you
in middle school.
You named yourself, huh?
I had a buddy in high school named Les Moore.
Oh, interesting.
Les Moore. Oh, okay.
Les is Moore.
Less is more. Keep them coming. 800-990-3776. Felony is such a cute name.
It is a felony. I might need to start like changing the meaning of that because I like that name a lot.
I remember my mom used to teach a young lady named Lil Cherry. L-I-L, and then Cherry was the name. So that's first name. First name was Lil Cherry.
That's but cute. I kind of like
was
that.
Was it Little or Lil?
It was Lil. L-I-L. Lil okay. Cherry. I never get that, actually. She was in the principal's office when I came to my mom. So she was probably angry because kids were making fun of her nonstop.
Yeah,
her name being Lil Cherry.
But I even think real quick of the Wiener you played with, the Kyle Wiener.
Kyle Wiener.
How much worse could it have been if the parents were just like, yeah, I mean, I'm going to go with, I mean, there's so many ways.
Their last name is Wiener.
Well, yeah, what if his first name was Mai? M-A-I. My.
Harry. I mean, Harry would be
yeah,
another
Harry,
one. Harry's
yeah,
common.
Yeah.
They
yeah.
can make it so much worse.
Is it common?
Harry, yeah.
Yeah, Harry's pretty
Harry
common.
Harry Douglas on I think he's Pat McAfee or yeah. ESPN.
You guys, it went over your head.
Oh, gotcha.
Oh.
Which potential ESPN Wisconsin ticket would you vote for, president and vice president of the USA? I had Jen Latta and Brian Balaga as vice president. Brad had Mark Tauscher with what is losing him the vote as Alex Stroh as his vice president. Chris Larson had Homer and Tory Lowe, the conspiracy ticket, and Kyle had Mark Chmura and Gabe Neitzel. Right now, Jen and Brian leading the way at 47.7%, Tausch and Stroh 36.6%, Homer and Tory in third place at 8%, and Chmura and Neitzel 7.6%. I do know that Rutledge and Hamilton are sad. That way they were not picked.
Oh, you've gotten
yeah,
the information.
I mean, because they tweeted, pick us.
Oh, they tweeted it
oh,
out.
Man. Oh, man.
I wonder what Jason Wilde will say tomorrow to Brad after he finds out that Alex Stroh was picked over him.
I mean,
we'll face it head on.
To be a business decision.
We will face it head on. Coming up next in 2 minutes, we will go through the Packers roster
And it is crazy how youthful they are. Their oldest player is 31. Their next oldest is 28. Religion Hamilton up next in Madison. We're back right here on 94.5 ESPN and on YouTube at ESPN Milwaukee in 2 minutes. Do not go anywhere. Go to the record store. You're gonna give
them all your Phillies continue around the Marquette interchange with the president in town. That's gumming up the works. Everybody's got to slow down until everything gets rolled through. So just be extra careful as you're heading through. Southbound 43 delays from Capitol Drive all the way down through the Marquette and over the high rise. Northbound's pretty backed up as well, making your way into the Marquette. We've also got eastbound 94 slowing down from Holly Road, pretty much solid all the way to about 35th Street, then right in the Marquette interchange as well. Traffic is brought to you by James Imaging Systems, your local document imaging partner. Visit jamesimaging.com. And check in the TMJ4 Storm Team forecast. Tonight, chance for showers and isolated thunderstorms with a low of 40. Tomorrow, rain showers are likely with an isolated thunderstorm with a high of 45. Weather is brought to you by Higher Love Cannabis Company. Find your Higher Love today only 59 miles from Green Bay. Find higherlove.com/CBD. From the WTMJ Traffic Center, I'm Debbie Lazaga on 94.5 ESPN.
We've told you about Moses Adara,
the diamond cutter who created the Kessler 81.
The magical diamond that vibrates with light.
Kessler's works with crazy diamond cutters.
Geniuses who create wonderful, spectacular,
crazy diamond shapes.
The one thing these crazy genius diamonds all have in common
is that they explode with light.
The Kessler Emerald Cut Diamond sends out rippling waves of light, like water lapping onto a beach.
The Kessler Square Radiant Diamond glows like the sun on the horizon.
Sometimes sunrise.
Sometimes sunset.
Come to Kessler's.
Come to Kessler's.
Come to Kessler's.
Ask to see the rippling waves of light, like water on the beach.
Ask to see the glow that looks like sunrise and sunset.
Ask to see the Kessler Crazy Genius Diamonds.
See them for yourself.
See them for yourself.
See them for yourself.
To find the Kessler's nearest you, visit kesslersdiamonds.com.
Marquette Hall of Famer Tony Smith here. You're listening to the home of Marquette basketball. 94.5 ESPN is WKTI and WKTI HD Milwaukee.
A locally owned Good Karma brand station.
Broadcasting live from the Gruber Law Office's One Call That's All studio at the Avenue in downtown Milwaukee. This is Kyle Bruston Nortman, KBN, on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
We the boys. We the boys.
It's the 414 hour at 4 on KBN.
And Brad Nortman on Hear Brad Out said that names need to be restricted. Today is living proof that they don't. We would not have been able to have as much fun as we did the last 20 minutes if names were restricted, Brad. Have you changed your tune at all?
No, because all I feel is pity and empathy for the poor souls who carry the names of what we talked about today. It's funny, for sure, but I could not imagine going through life with that name.
Ty in the 920 chimes in. My last name is Bader. Everyone calls me. I'm going to leave that for everyone to fill in the blank.
Look at this. Look at all how people just get criticized, crucified, and made fun of as kids. Little poor BJ over here. He used to be BJ. He turned to a whole new person in bed. I would love to call you BJ.
You have to change your identity.
I mean, if you guys call me BJ, I'm fine with it because I went by BJ. Like, there's still people in my childhood who know me as BJ Brust. I think it would have been cool. BJ Brust, 4-3.
Like, yeah.
I could have been cool. Like, I would have leaned into it. That's what I'm saying. All these fun names, you got to lean into them.
But yeah.
Otherwise, you get made fun of.
But BJ is common enough where it's, like, not that bad. Like, I mean, you can take it to that level. But some of these are, like the caller who called in, Harry, last name, whole, middle name A. Like, that's just no way.
I like the way you did that. Yeah. So it wasn't a direct in line
there.
There's
just no way you can get around
that. I wanted the direct in line.
Of course you did. 800-990-3776. Justin in the 262. I work as a school photographer in Milwaukee, so I see a ton of odd names.
Ooh, I know you do.
But this one takes the cake. It was How's your mama?
I'm telling you right now.
How's your mama?
Wow. I used to substitute teach in MPS, and one of the most fun things I did was going through. You don't have to do roll call, but the whole fact that when you mess up on kids' name, everybody laughs.
There's a whole skit on Key and Peele about, you know,
it was so
Aaron and
it
all that.
Was so fun to build that connection with the kids. When I went through the list, I would be going down the list and they'd be correcting me and everybody like, he's so stupid. I said, no, your parents are so stupid. But just keep going down
you
the
said
list.
That?
I've said things. I didn't say that to the kids. I thought it in my head. But I said some things to these
if
babies.
If you got them, please keep them coming. 800-990-3776. Mike in the 608. I had a job placing name place cards on doors. One time, one lady was D. Nutter.
Oh, man.
Yeah, that's tough.
That is tough. What are these people thinking?
I mean, why D?
Like D-E-E?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought it was like maybe like the first initial.
No.
But they went all in.
They went all in.
See, that there's no
excuse
for that.
That's where you're saying there needs to be a restriction?
No excuse. I mean, maybe take your mind off the gutter.
Because they're trying to make it bad at that point. Has to be.
Jacob of the 920 grew up on the east side of Madison. Our neighbor was named Richard, and Hacker was his last name. You guys can do the rest there. Mm. Keep them coming, 800-990-ESPN.
Can I just say, like,
you can
names
say whatever
like,
you want. You're part of the show.
Oh, I know we have. They're just weird names. Like, who decided that Hunter, and shout out to all the Hunters we know.
We have a producer in Madison, Hunter Vaughn.
I know, but what I'm saying is this, like, who thought that Hunter was a good name, right? You go from hunting and you call him Hunter.
I mean, we just heard the clip of, you know, names like Felony. And somebody says they know a Felony. I don't believe
really?
That. It's a cute name.
It is cute.
If you get past the meaning. Scott and Racine, 800-990-3776. I could do this all day. I'm a child. Welcome in. Scott, you there?
Hello, how you doing?
Hey,
hello.
We're doing good, Scott.
Hey, Scott.
Yeah, my buddy, growing up, my best friend had a neighbor. His name was Richard Shrink.
Oh, man.
Nice.
That hits too close to home, Scott. Thank you for the call. 800-990-3776. What are you laughing at, Brad and Kyle? You jumped in Lake Michigan too.
Yeah,
that's why Kyle ran away so fast.
We've all been.
I want to protect my baby.
We've all been Richard Shrink at one point or another, haven't we? We can all relate.
Ainsley.
Yeah, that's a stupid name too.
She just checked. She just texted in.
Shut up. Jeez.
I don't. Ainsley, I value you.
I like that name.
I like that name. And Kyle just out here ripping KVN Nation right now. What was that? Think before you speak. Get back over here. Do the show and apologize to Ainsley.
I like that.
Before
name.
I read Ainsley's text, you need to apologize.
Hey, Ainsley, I apologize. Is it Ainsley a man or woman?
I don't know.
I think it's a girl name.
Ainsley, your name is beautiful.
Kyle, I think
you're so insincere.
Like,
it's a stupid name.
Well, here's the thing. No, it's a made-up name. Where did it come from?
Where did all these come from?
I don't know. Kyle sounds pretty original and, you know, normal. But Ainsley, I'm sure it is a beautiful name. Like, all these names are beautiful. Like, we talk about Felony. Like, it's a beautiful name. It's
look
just,
at this. Backpedal Kyle Wallace back again.
I think Kyle was just in, like, kill mode, you know what I mean, with, like, all these names and just ready to pounce when he heard one. So
you said Ainsley?
And you go, that's stupid. Ainsley chimes in and says,
beautiful name.
Kid I graduated high school with, 5'3", 105, Harley David Slim.
Come on.
Yeah, I trust KBN Nation. I ain't going to.
So like
and I'm not going to absolutely just destroy them for male death to Kyle, says Ainsley.
That's one where they're just trying to be funny.
Wait a minute. Oh, wait,
with the last name Slim like that.
Yeah, for sure they're trying. That's what I'm saying. These parents are trying to mess their kids up.
Oh, I apologize, Ainsley.
Niall.
That's a stupid one. Niall.
Niall and Team Oscom, welcome in.
Why'd you do that to me?
Hey, thanks.
Niall, hey. What's wrong with Kyle, man?
I know a Niall. Send a Niall.
Killing people.
800-990.
Named after a river.
3776. It's your floor, Niall, and do whatever you can to rip Kyle while you're at it.
Hey, I knew a guy. He owned a very large business, and his name was Richard Wacker.
Yeah, these are.
You can take it.
These are
you can
common.
Call him, and you could call him Dick all you wanted. So
yeah, it's his name.
He didn't mind.
He didn't mind, and because it's his name. Now I'm mad at Niall for not taking offense to the fact that Kyle, for two times in a row, just destroyed KBN Nation fans.
Yeah, I mean, I can keep going. Y'all got some weird names. Ripping is another one. And the way people spell some names, like the way people spell, like, with the L-E-E or whatever it is.
Huh?
Like,
yeah, that's a thing now.
Yeah, when you, I don't know, but like, if you spell Paisley and you spell it with L-E-E and things like that, this is some weird
things. Just don't like change.
I don't. I really don't. Ashley, shout out to all the Ashleys out there with a weirdly spelled. I just don't like weird spell. I'm traditional.
Wait, how is Ashley weirdly spelled?
A lot of different ways.
Yeah, I think people who spell Ashley with
apparently,
yeah, okay, but that's gotcha. It's wonderful. You know, to each your own. I work with a Danielle who literally her first her name is Danyale.
Tim and West Alice, thank you for having a regular name in Tim so Kyle didn't jump all over your name. Welcome into Kyle Bruston-Ortman, 800-990-ESPN.
Thanks for having me. I have a grandchild, 2 years old, and her name is Errol. It's a Scottish female name. I don't know how to spell it, O-E-I-E-R-O or whatever.
Wait a minute, you don't know how to spell your grandbaby's name?
I don't know how to spell it, no. And she just had a baby brother 2 weeks now. Baby brother's name is Bo.
What's wrong with Bo?
Bo is in B-O or Bo is in B-A-U or B-E-A-U?
Whatever you want. It's bow and arrow.
Yo, my man Tim is bow upset. Hey, my man Tim doesn't like his grandchild's name.
Hey, well, you said, what to name my grandbaby? Arrow. What is she, Robin Hood?
I don't know how to spell it. I don't want to learn.
And arrow.
Bow and arrow.
Crazy.
Obviously, he knows his daughter or his son, wherever it was, must like marijuana Pepsi. Must like that.
Yeah. Well, when you reference marijuana Pepsi, that is a real person.
It is a real person. Marijuana Pepsi Jackson. Real person.
I just can't believe that. He must have just been thinking like a grandfather. Just being like, what are we doing here? My legacy.
Yeah, right? Bow and arrow.
I like that guy. Tim, I like Tim. Tim got a nice original name and a realistic attitude.
Well, and each time we were like, how do you spell it? He's like, I don't even know. Who cares? Like, neither. You could get either one.
Spell it whatever way you want to.
Chris in Germantown, 800-990-3776. Your name. Not Chris, but what do you got for us?
Okay, so with my sister-in-law, they had their son about 15 years ago, and there was an Arabic couple that gave birth to a son, and they wanted to name the kid Shatid, an Arabic name, but in English it was basically spelled bleephead.
Oh, no.
You get my meaning.
Yes,
so
we do.
The nurses and staff were trying to convince them. They were like, it's a good name, but in America, it's not going to work. So they were trying to like convince them to change the kid's name or at least change the spelling so you didn't have a kid walking around being, you know, bleephead.
Like, how does the teacher in school read that? Thank you, Chris.
This is proving it.
You literally said that in Hear Brad Out. If you missed Hear Brad Out, that's how we've got here. It was at 3:30. Go to WisconsinOnDemand.com. Brad, your qualifications were?
I said the doctor, nurse, and one other family member should all have to check off on the name. Because if not for the doc, who's the person that was the hero in that story?
The doctor? Nurse?
Or somebody in the medical?
Yeah, he's,
like,
no one was the hero. I don't think they got him to change the name.
No, I thought they did. I thought he said they did.
Oh, I stopped listening because I started thinking of a bleep head.
Yeah, I was laughing too hard too. But at least somebody made an effort to be like, look, maybe you're not seeing this, but even if you are, somebody needs to be some wise counsel for you because you're setting this kid up for a lifelong, you know,
bleep head.
Yes.
And you need that because a lot of times during pregnancy, after people have babies, as you know, Ben just had a baby, said they drug a lot of these women up in order to, you know, take away pain. So
all right, Michelle in Kenosha, 800-990-ESPN.
Hi there. I got a name. Her name was Ashole, but it was spelled A-S-S-H-O-L-E.
Oh, wow.
Oh, come on.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. No, Ashole. That was a teacher. Yeah, my mother-in-law's friends.
Well, thank you for the call. Wow. 800-990-ESPN. I've had a lot of fun with this, but I think it's time to move on.
You didn't like Ashole?
I liked Ashole. I don't like the spelling of Ashole. So we're going to go 800-990-ESPN and move on to what will be a Josh Jacobs in a youth conversation with the Green Bay Packers. I could do this all day, but I do think we need to talk about the day that was
Monday that carries into today. 800-990-ESPN.
This is Kyle Bruston Nortman, KBN.
I think it's clear.
Yeah, and if Doc replicates what Booty did last year, or all of all,
His name is Coach Bud.
If he replicates
Coach Booty,
what Coach Bud
on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
Still have some delays along southbound 43 as you're making your way down from Capitol Drive all the way down through the Marquette. So that's going to be a bit of a tight squeeze. So give yourself that extra time, 16 minutes to get from Brown Deer Road into downtown. Westbound 94, a little tight from 35th Street out to Mitchell Boulevard. We've also got some delays along southbound 41 from Silver Spring down past Capitol and the northbound side from Watertown Plank Road up past North Avenue where there is a broken down vehicle. Looks like we've also got some possible lane closures because of some debris in that area, so be extra careful as you are out and about. Traffic is brought to you by Johnson & Sons Paving. Potholes are a pain when they pop up in your asphalt. Johnson & Sons Paving can patch or replace the whole lot. Book an appointment now at johnsonandsonspaving.com. And check in the TMJ4 Storm Team forecast. Tonight, chance for showers and isolated thunderstorm with a low of 40. Tomorrow, rain showers likely, chance for isolated thunder with a high of 45. From the WTMJ Traffic Center, I'm Debbie Lazaga on 94.5 ESPN.
He's the most interesting man in sports radio.
Well, should I have a chip on my shoulder that I'm not making as much money as Skip Bayless?
In his mind, anyway. The Homer Hour with special guests every day from 5 to 6.
When you say they gave it away, what's at the top of your list?
Get him off the field on third down.
The Homer Hour with Homer. Weekdays from 5 to 6. Right here on 94.5 ESPN and streaming live on YouTube.
Hey, it's Gabe Neitzel from Jen, Gabe, and Chewy. You've heard me talk about the results mentality has had on my life, but don't just take it from me. Jason has had success too, thanks to mentality.
My only regret is I didn't do it sooner. Knowing once again I've gotten the treatments done and continuing, I do feel, you know, stuff does hurt a little bit more, but I'm 40, you know, in my 40s, and that's going to happen. But again, the energy levels, it is above and beyond. Again, it's I'm back in that age where I'm like, this is amazing.
Get started today at OTUSA.com.
Elevate your game day gear or any outfit with official merchandise from the Milwaukee Bucks Pro Shop. From authentic jerseys to exclusive apparel and accessories, the Bucks Pro Shop has everything you need to showcase your fandom wherever you go. Cheer the deer to victory with authentic Milwaukee Bucks items. Visit us at the Bucks Pro Shop at Fiserv Forum or Bayshore Mall, or shop online at shop.bucks.com.
It's March Mania time at all Milwaukee Metro Region Cunis Auto Group dealerships.
5 seconds left. Drives. Scores!
That means choosing from the area's biggest selection plus saving thousands from the Midwest's top-ranked automotive dealer. Your nearby Cunis Auto Group dealership featuring America's number one rated starting lineup from Buick and GMC. At nearby locations in both Greenfield and Oak Creek, we've got the only March Mania sales event in the Milwaukee Metro Region where everyone's a winner.
For the lead.
We're putting on a full court press to sell over 500 new and used vehicles in March. No other competitor can go one-on-one with the deals from the Cunis Auto Group team. Our Cunis sales MVPs lead the league in assist to our customers. So getting the vehicle of your needs at a price and payment you can afford is a slam dunk. Plus, we're paying above top Kelley Blue Book values on all trade-ins, no matter what the mileage or condition. So buy like a champion today at your nearby Milwaukee Metro Region Cunis Auto Group dealership or online at shopcunis.com.
Stay up to date on the Green and Gold all off season. The Green and Gold Fix podcast is brought to you by Potawatomi Casino Hotel. Luxury stay, elite play, unwind in sophisticated comfort. Win big, dine, and experience the events in Milwaukee.
1 in 10 young adults will experience a form of homelessness this year.
For over 50 years, Covenant House has been helping youth in crisis. To learn more, go to covenanthouse.org today.
This is Kyle Bruston-Nortman on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
I'ma take a bougie to Rodeo and then let her pick up whatever she want. CC Gucci, Hippo, take her whatever she want.
Boy, spring coming early out there. You see how nice it is outside? Sure you do, because you're driving around and you're looking outside and you're seeing exactly what it is. Well, it was nice outside, but it's about to be more time to enjoy that nice weather. But you can't do that if you have aching, painful joints. That's where my friends at QC Kinetics, they can help you. That's because they utilize treatment that's been available for pro athletes like me for decades, but now it's available to everyone out there. They're utilizing it. They are the ones that are figuring out how they can get rid of your surgery, of no drugs, no surgery, no downtime, to get rid of your lasting joint pain relief. This is not a band-aid. This is a long-term fix by the nation's leader in regenerative medicine. By taking your body's own healing properties and being able to allow the healing and restoration that your body needs. Now take it from me, there's been tens of thousands of satisfied patients who have reclaimed their mobility. So if you want to enjoy all the nice weather we've been having and we're going to have in the future, so you can walk and run and golf and climb stairs and do all the things you want to do and live a life of motion, QC Kinetics is for you. Call QC Kinetics today for a free consultation at 414-285-3474. That's 414-285-3474. 414-285-3474.
We are Kyle Bruston-Nortman on 94.5 ESPN, and it's been a fun show, but I do want to get back to the conversation that is the Green Bay Packers, because when you look at this team, they're young, man. And shout out to Andy Herman, because he tweeted this, and I thought it was super interesting. The Packers over the age of 28 on this roster is only one name, Preston Smith. Everyone else on the roster currently is 28 or younger. And that includes Kenny Clark, which feels like he's been on the Packers for 15 years. 28-year-olds, Kenny Clark, Elgton Jenkins, Alex Magoo, and Matt Orzech.
No, a lot of non-contributors.
Matt Orzech, long snapper. Thank you very much.
Non-contributor.
Replaceable. Replaceable.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
Non-contributor.
Easily replaceable. Wow, not on this show you'll say that.
27-year-olds. Jair Alexander, Zane Anderson, and Corey Ballantyne. Green Bay has 8 players 27 or older. Why that's fascinating is obviously you just hear it and it's fascinating. But can they win a Super Bowl with this youth, right? Like, can they win a Super? They brought in Jacobs and McKinney in free agency. They're going to draft. They have 11 picks. I think 7 or 8 of them will end up on the roster likely-ish.
Not about right, yeah.
And they're not going to be above 28. So I love it, because if I'm being honest, it scares me for the Super Bowl, but excites me about the youth, the speed, because that's been the difference for this team. Last year, what was different was the youth, the speed, especially offensively, right?
Well, the quarterback.
Sure. I mean, look, Rodgers was becoming less mobile. Mm-hmm. Father Time is undefeated.
You saw it.
And one thing I think we all like to see is Jordan Love step up and use his legs a little bit more in situations, not all the time, but just having, like, he'll grow the pocket awareness of when it might be time for him to, I mean, do what Brock Purdy did to the Packers, to be honest. Brock Purdy is probably equal to athleticism of Love from a running perspective, and I think sometimes he just took off and ran because of the zone coverage that the Packers would play, and he'd find his areas and go. So do you think this team can win a Super Bowl with the youth? I mean, it's kind of scary.
Well, look, odds are against them. We'll put it that way, right? Because it's hard to get really great stats about average team age, about winning the Super Bowl, because it's sort of all over the place. But from what I can find, it's usually like 27 or 28 years old. 27 or 28 years old, that the average age of the team, which makes sense, right? You sprinkle in some youth, you sprinkle in some vets, and then, you know, you maybe got like a 35-year-old and you got a 24-year-old. So usually you're like mid to high 20s, somewhere in there, for a team that's, one, experienced enough, but two, young enough with a bunch of freshness. Maybe they'll go in there and win a Super Bowl. Another stat I found, average age of Super Bowl winning quarterback. 30.5.
Oh, wow.
Much older. Usually it takes some time for these guys to figure it out. We all know Jordan Love is much younger than that. But, you know, Patrick Mahomes has been doing it, and Tom Brady's an outlier.
But when you say Patrick Mahomes, not only has he been doing it, he's been winning a lot of them.
He has been winning a lot of them.
I mean, it's interesting, but, like,
You're asking Jordan Love at age what?
25 this year. I think it was 24 to start the season, right?
I think it's fair to say that, like, again, in his second year of starting, the Packers have built a good roster, but it's also a lot to ask him to win a Super Bowl at that age as well.
Yeah, so just my take is that it's an uphill battle for them. A young team, there are some great benefits of a young team. They should stay healthier. They're probably faster. They're very hungry because they want to go out there and make their money. But on the flip side, experience does matter. This team would no doubt be the youngest team ever by a long shot to win a Super Bowl if they do win a Super Bowl. That probably goes for this year. That probably goes for next year too. So they would be historically young winning a Super Bowl. They can do it because they have the talent to do it. But in my experience, having some guys that have been there that can mentor you, that have comfortability in there, that can prepare you for those moments, it's pretty helpful. So that's maybe a guy like Bobby Wagner, like you said earlier in the show, Kyle. Even if you need to tick that average age up, there is some benefit of older, been there, done that guys.
Yes, the Packers, listen, the Packers can win with a young roster. They have the talent, and what they showed last year is they showed that with a young team, they are still able to go into big-time situations and deliver big-time games. That is that experience that they gained last year, experience means everything. Age ain't nothing but a number. But experience, that's the thing that really matters. And the Packers got valuable experience for their young guns, for their young team, in order to live on that and move forward and use that experience to be better. Now, in order to win championships, Brad and Ben, you have to have a mix of veteran leadership. And we talked about it earlier. You just talked about Bobby Wagner. Yes, you have to have a mix in order to win. There is no team that has won a Super Bowl purely by being just young. They had veteran leadership on offense and defense that was able to help you along the way. That is the missing piece for the Green Bay Packers. So the whole thing that Goody wants to do is, how can you put this team in a position to win a title? You can keep them young, but you need to look at history in order to form the future. And forming the future and forming the now is by putting the right veteran pieces that may be a little bit older on this team for them to be successful. So as they are now, can they win a championship? Yes, they can win a championship, but everybody likes a sure thing. And again, nothing in football is a sure thing, but I feel a lot more confident if you added another or two, a veteran or two who may be a little bit older. They may be 28 and older. They may be in their 30s, but they can contribute to this team right now.
Eight players over the age of 27 years old on the Green Bay Packers roster. I think it's interesting because obviously we're excited with changes, right? Like, for good or for bad, however you look at it, there's still an excitement level, knowing that Goody spent money in free agency, bringing in Xavier McKinney, bringing in Josh Jacobs, and who knows what's next. I guess Keyshawn Nixon bringing backs. But the NFL championship odds to win per Pato Sportsbook: the Niners plus 550, Chiefs plus 650, Ravens plus 950, Bills plus 1200, Bengals plus 1300, Lions plus 1300, Cowboys plus 1500, Eagles plus 1600, then the Packers at plus 2000. So I find that fascinating, that I think they've been jumped by the Eagles and the Cowboys. And the Lions being ahead of them by, you know, a good margin.
Aaron Jones impact. That's the effect. You lose Aaron Jones.
No, the Packers went from 2,200 to 2,000.
Oh, they went up. I thought they were down.
They went up, but others, you know, the Eagles made some big moves. So, I mean, obviously, because the odds are what they are, it doesn't mean it's going to play out that way. But at the same time, the Niners and the Chiefs have ended up in the Super Bowl against each other twice in the last 4 years.
Yeah, and you know, ironically, the thing that I'm most concerned about, offense, defense, a little bit of special teams for sure, but it's the defensive side of the ball, and that's where most of the vets are, right? Most of the young guys are actually on offense. That's the thing I'm most confident in right now with the Green Bay Packers. So that's where you said, Kyle, that was a great point that you said, where it's not necessarily the age, it's the experience. This team has gotten experience. This team has, because of everything they went through last year, hot start, a tough middle of the season, go on some must-win games and play in some big playoff games. They got the experience of like 3 years jammed into 1 year. So this team can, they can make a run and they can win a Super Bowl because of what happened last year.
Mm-hmm. Against all odds last year, against the fact that, hey, a number seven seed has never beaten, never won a playoff game. What did they do? Like Ben said, they slaughtered them. Oh, San Francisco's tough. They're a one seed. They're hungry. What did they do? If it wasn't for Anderson Carlson, we would have probably been playing in the NFC Championship game. This team has the ingredients in order to win, but again, I want my food to taste delicious and getting a little bit more, you know, putting a little bit more salt.
Some age,
more,
you know? Yeah. You want it to simmer a little bit.
Yeah,
you know?
Cook it a little bit longer. Get something else in there.
Marinate.
Marinate.
Chef Ed agrees. Kyle is 100% right. 800-990-3776. The ESPN Wisconsin Talking Text Line. Kyle Bruston-Ortman discussing the youth of the Packers roster. We need a veteran to lead this team to the Super Bowl. And part of me is with it. But I think when you look at the eight guys above 27 years old, is Kenny Clark going to be the guy to lead them? Is Jair Alexander a guy that you can count on to be a leader for this team based off coin flip gate? I don't know. Can you trust him?
Well, and that's where Jason Lilly makes a good point when he joined our show and said he doesn't know who's going to be the next guy that's going to fill in the Aaron Jones role, the Donald Driver role. It's in the locker room. It has to be in the locker room. I hope it's Jordan Love, maybe Jaden Reed. Somebody on defense, though, needs to step up and be that guy. Maybe it's McKinney.
He was a captain.
Maybe it's McKinney.
I think this is just very reflective of the lack of what Goody has done in order to put guys in a position to be that confident, right? And you've been in a locker room. You've been in a locker room, but you've been in an NFL locker room. The weakest dude on the team ain't the one that's saying the loudest speaker. They're not the one they're following. You know what I'm saying? Nobody's following Eric Wilson on the Green Bay Packers. We don't know who Eric Wilson is? Yeah, because Eric Wilson's a guy that just, you know, recovered a fumble. They're not following Eric Wilson. No shot at you, Brad, but people weren't following Brad Norman. If Brad said, hey, come here, bring in the huddle. No, they're following who? Cam Newton, Steve Smith. The guys that contribute the most on the football field are the ones that have the biggest voice. Unfortunately, the Green Bay Packers don't have those dogs on defense that pop out and say, hey, we gonna make a play here and I'm gonna do it. Those are the type of guys that you follow because you know when they speak, when they say it, they're going to follow through, and you know you can follow those dudes in the war. And the Packers are just missing that one piece. Jair could be it, but he just doesn't have that the maturity to do it. Maybe Xavier McKinney comes in and do it.
There's a lack of awareness for Jair. But McKinney might be it. Maybe he will be.
That might be the piece.
I mean, maybe because Jair has had like that de facto like – you're our guy, you're our all pro, like maybe he will thrive not being the guy in terms of like the only guy on the back end that is a stud from a name perspective and a position perspective. Xavier McKinney might be able to take, you know, ownership of that back end of the defense, and you just let Jair do his thing. Let him talk his stuff. Let him be out on an island, a little bit more man pressed that hopefully we'll see with the Jeff Hafley, and McKinney can be a guy that we don't have to count on Jair to be a captain ever.
I think that would be an ideal situation because not only for Jair's personality, like you said, Ben, but like the cornerback safety relationship. Cornerbacks it's a bit more one-on-one. It's a bit more isolated. Safety, you're kind of governing the whole field. Mm. So if you could select where my captain is going to be, I'll take middle linebacker or I'll take safety.
Yeah, I love that. I love that. I hope Jair can, because he's very... the impact he has on this team is ridiculous. You know, the corners who all do things just like him. So he does have a little bit of that influence. That maturity just needs to come along for him to be great.
800-990-3776. Get your texts, and we'll also get to Ben's same game parlay. We're one of like eight. And if we hit another, we'll be in the positive. Come on, I need some help. Let's win some games. Ben's same game parlay. Do I parlay it or I just pick one game and go big? We'll find out what happens next.
This is Kyle Bruston-Ortman.
Ben's pretty good at impersonations.
Hey, he's
quotes.
Pretty good.
I
either crush him or suck at him.
He's pretty good at faking it.
Yeah. Yeah, being a faker.
Yeah,
that's exactly what it is.
Why can't
we come together?
Yeah,
you're
very creative in faking it. Good job.
On ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
So far, we are moving along relatively well. It is a little slow on the southbound bypass, basically from Lincoln down towards the Hale Interchange. Westbound 894 going to be slowing down out of the Mitchell Interchange out past Loomis. Heavy ride along southbound 43 from about Keefe all the way down through the Marquette and over the high-rise bridge. Doesn't really let up till you get past the KK River. Traffic is brought to you by James Imaging Systems, your local document imaging partner. Visit jamesimaging.com. And checking the TMJ4 Storm Team forecast tonight. Mostly cloudy, chance of showers, a low of 42. Tomorrow, cloudy and rainy, half inch to an inch of rain possible with a high of 45. From the WTMJ Traffic Center, I'm Debbie Lozaga on 94.5 ESPN.
This is ESPN Wisconsin's Brad Nortman, here to tell you about my favorite go-to drink. That's Carbliss. Carbliss is a ready-to-drink, handcrafted vodka and tequila cocktail. Even better, it's zero carbs, zero sugar, zero gluten, and just 100 calories. And listen to this, less carbonation. This leads to less bloat. I can indulge in something delicious without having that health guilt. Carbliss is crafted right here in Wisconsin. It has a flavor for everyone, from black raspberry to cranberry, pineapple and lemon, and my favorite, margarita. Find Carbliss online and at a retailer near you. Less is more.
Right now, the prices of diamonds are probably the lowest we'll see in our lifetime.
Diamond prices are low, low, low. Here's why.
It was hard to meet new people during COVID.
When a person meets their soulmate, they usually get engaged about 39 months later.
People started dating again only about 36 months ago.
Most of the people who got engaged during COVID
or immediately after COVID
were already in a relationship before the COVID lockdown began.
The Wall Street Journal even published a story about all of this.
Low sales of engagement rings created a worldwide oversupply of diamonds.
But now, engagement ring sales are beginning to pick up again.
By the end of next spring, this temporary oversupply will be gone.
And diamond prices will start climbing like crazy.
If you ever wanted to own a big diamond, this is the year to do it.
Find the Kesslers nearest you at kesslersdiamonds.com.
If you want to own a big diamond, the time is now.
My house has a new glow. I love my windows. Universal Windows Direct.
Hey, it's Kyle Walls, and right now, schedule your free in-home estimate, and for every two windows you buy, you get the next two free, plus a free upgrade to triple-pane glass, and they'll double your energy tax credit. Restrictions apply. You'll be saying, I love my windows.
I love my windows. They've got that brand new home effect. Universal Windows Direct.
It's time for the Ortho ASAP Minute from Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin.
I'm here with Dr. Sam Steiner. How much do you enjoy being able to help someone through really the entire process of coming back from an injury?
I mean, I think it's something very special. It's something I look forward to every day, being able to wake up, see people from the time they're injured, and then take them all the way through the process of explaining what they've had done, taking care of them, in some cases operating on them, and then afterwards being able to see the recovery and see them get back to where they want to be.
It seems to me that there is a strong connection between patient and doctor here. Why is that?
Many of us grew up in the area. We went to high schools that we now take care of. I think it's really unique and special that we can take care of people we went to school with, their families, friends of our parents at our facility. It holds you accountable. They can literally say, hey, if you don't do a good job, I'm going to tell your mom. We really have something very special and unique here at OAW.
The Ortho ASAP Minute is sponsored by Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin. There is a difference.
This is Kyle Bruston-Nortman, KBN, on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
On fire to keep you on.
Kyle Wallace here for the Bath Authority, and I want you to know if your bath or your shower is old or outdated, has mold or mildew, any broken tiles, I don't want you to deal with that anymore. I know when you go in there, you say, oh, man, I need to do an upgrade. Well, you know what? My friends at the Bath Authority, they can take good care of you. They have the highest quality bathroom remodeling products, and guess what? They give you a world-class customer experience, and that is very important. Every unit they build is custom-built. You pick the premium accents and accessories, and they have great safety features like low-profile showers. They have grab bars and shower seats. They'll take care of you. And listen, all Bath Authority products, they're made right here in the U.S. say and can be installed in as little as one day by a certified vacuum technician. You don't need somebody going in and out your house over and over and over and over. Nope, they'll take care of it in as little as one day. No hassle. So I want you to call them today at 414-249-6934 and get $1,000 off a new shower bath plus 36 months of interest-free financing. Elevate your bathroom to a new level of luxury, style, and safety, and call my friends at 414-249-6934 to schedule your in-home free estimate and get $1,000 off your new shower plus 36 months of free interest-free financing. Call the Bath Authority. Contact the Bath Authority. Visit them today at thebathauthority.com, where a better bath awaits.
Kyle Bruston-Nortman across ESPN Wisconsin. Up on Twitter at KBN ESPN.
Which potential ESPN Wisconsin ticket would you vote for president and VP of the U.S.? And A, Ben Brust, I had Jen Latta and Brian Bilaga. Jen was the third pick as president, and Bilaga on the way back with the sixth pick was my VP. Brad Nortman had Tausch number one overall and Strofe number eight, which was a stupid decision that lost him the vote. Kyle Wallace had Mark Chmura and Gabe Neitzel. Dead last. Oh, nope. The conspiracy theory ticket that Chris had, and Homer and Tory Lowe, 6.6%. And that led our fellow show on from 4 to 6 on ESPN Madison. Our first poll question, which combination of the KBN hosts would you vote in for a hypothetical race of the President of the United States? Brust and Nortman, Wallace and Nortman, or Wallace and Brust? And I turn it to you guys for quickly, where would you place your vote on this poll?
Oh, wow.
You don't have to pull it up. We're right here.
Okay, true.
You're choosing.
Kyle, I'll let you go first.
If it was hypothetical, who was running for the president?
Like, which combination of us three?
It would be us two. It would 100% be us. I don't even know. It's not even a question. Like, it would be me and you if we had to run for the president of the United States. One of us be the leader. I wouldn't trust him to be the leader of the country.
I would say
I want to be VP.
I would say I want to win. And I think that Ben might be too polarizing for my ticket. So I think I might have to go with Kyle. I think he'd pass.
Polarizing?
Yeah.
He's too emotional.
A lot of people don't like.
He can't make decisions in distress.
I can be stoic when I need to be, man. But when it comes to the people of KBN Nation, I got your back.
You know how to spin it, Kyle.
I'm
standing
behind
him. And then he'll backpedal the next day.
No,
he's a perfect politician.
No, not at all.
Plays both sides.
And you don't know what you're going to. He's unpredictable. You don't know what you're going to get from Ben Brust. You can't vote for somebody unpredictable. He'll push that dang button. He'll push the button.
That's a strong accusation. The nuclear codes, he's saying, I'd blow up the world.
Yeah, okay.
He'll push it.
You're the worst.
Also, another Rush Hour reference.
I chose Brust and Wallace, and I'm regretting it. And the reason why, Brad, is I think we're too similar.
I could see that.
We're both whiteies.
Yeah, we are.
Oh, wow.
We are.
I mean, we're both basic whiteies.
Oh, wow.
Brad and Ben.
It's a very... Okay. I was gonna say this with our personality. I say it's a very vanilla ticket. That's why I paused.
Y'all racist against your own people.
It doesn't have a lot of flavor, pizzazz. Kyle Wallace brings that flavor and pizzazz. He brings the excitement. I'm not sure we'd be able to really, Ben, I'm not sure you and I would be able to get out the voter excitement.
Bro, you ain't got to explain nothing to him. Ain't nobody voting for him. It's us, too. They would vote for us, whether you're president, I'm VP, you're VP. It doesn't matter. We are a great balanced combination.
I could see that.
All right.
Very optimistic, too. We are going in the right direction, America.
Exactly.
I'm going to be unpredictable and choose three random games for my same game parlay.
It's time for Ben's same game parlay. Sponsored by Pottawatomie Casino Hotel. There's a table waiting for you at Pottawatomie Casino Hotel. 12 bars and restaurants, a winning seat at 40 table games or 3,000 slot machines, and full-service sports betting. Explore more at paysbig.com.
All right, each of us are going to get a pick against the spread here, and we're going to parlay three games.
Oh, I'm back. Okay. I thought I got
kicked
out. All right.
See, I forgive. I'm a good leader.
Very presidential.
I do declare you dead to me after 5 o'clock, though. We're going to pick three 10:30 games because I like the night games. I like to wake up or stay locked in. Kyle, I'm going to give you Abilene Christian versus Stephen F. Austin. This is obviously a neutral site. Stephen F. Austin is -3.5 against Abilene Christian.
All right. You know what? I'm gonna go with I don't even know what seed these people are.
Like, that's the point. I'm trying to win off luck.
And what is the spread?
Stephen F. Austin -3.5 against Abilene Christian.
So Stephen F. Austin is the
favorite.
Well, let's go with Stephen F. Austin. I've seen them in the tournament before. Let's go with them. I'm going with old Texas.
They are clicked. Brad, would you like the battle of the Montanas, Montana State versus Montana, or UC Santa Barbara versus UC CSU Northridge?
Give me the Montanas.
The Montanas.
Montanas.
Montana, -6 against Montana State.
Wow. Big spread. Big spread in that game. I'm going to go with... Give me the... Ooh. No, I'm not going with Montana State. I just looked at their web record. They're under 500. Go with the favor. Go with Montana.
Is it the Big Sky?
Big Sky. Yeah. Montana State, they're under 500. They've lucked their way here. Montana Grizzlies. How are you going to bet against the Grizzlies? Give me the Grizzlies big.
Can't... Under 500 in yours, the one I just picked, there's a 6 versus 7 seed. Both these teams suck.
That's what I love about college basketball. You get to watch some bad basketball. Someone could airball, brick, turnover, any play. They're very frustrating. I don't know if we can go chalk here and go favorite. I'm going to finish this and we'll get to that, Kyle, because that is definitely his news. I'm going to go with Arizona State. You know what? Three favorites. Utah. Three favorites. $30.
Let's get nuts!
30 to win 180. What do we think?
Yeah, woo!
I like it.
I like it, too. I feel good.
I like my pick. Montana's blowing everybody out.
I don't know anything about my pick other than the fact that...
Stephen F. Austin's been in the tournament.
Yeah, I've seen him before in a tournament.
All right, well, the news of the day now for our show is Kyle and Brad have lobbied from 2 to 4:43 to have a veteran leadership, a veteran presence, especially at that linebacker position. You guys want to break the news? You want to do my job?
This is why I'm a reforming hater. You can break it. I'm just saying, this is why I'm a reforming hater of Brian Gutekunst.
Well, you're the one that brought him up, Kyle, but we're seeing news that linebacker Bobby Wagner signing with the Washington Commanders on a very pedestrian $8 million deal. I just went away, so I missed it on the TV.
Yeah, $8.5 million, $6 million guaranteed.
I mean, I guess that's kind of a lot for a 33-year-old, but we got the cap room.
I mean, I'm pretty sure they were paying DeVondre Campbell more than that, if I'm not mistaken.
That's true. That's a hard one to see.
This is where the frustration just comes in, is because we get so far, right? We make these moves, but we just don't put the cherry on top. I want the cherry on top.
The cherry's not done yet.
You're right. Let me not get emotional. Let me get 24 hours.
24 hours for Kyle Wallace. Is it Wednesday?
It is Wednesday.
Hump day.
Homer reacts to his... presidential election on ESPN Wisconsin next.
This is Kyle Brustin Nortman, KBN.
You should be happy Pac-Man Jones has had this on his headphones, or he definitely would have pulled it up on you.
I think Pac-Man's lucky I didn't have this on my headphones.
Oh, you right?
I would have been. I'm really feeling swaggy and confident.
You say, yeah, you're in my space. Oh, what you gonna do?
Because even just hearing the song, like, for those who are on the YouTube, they can see I'm bobbing my head right now. Like, this is like, okay.
Go ahead, say ski. Ski.
On ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com. Football Guy.
What the hell happened to Bucky on your hat?
Football Guy.
A lot of wear and tear for old B.
Coming at it from different views.
I'm just saying, he's well-worn. I mean, his face is missing. Okay, well, it's probably time for me to freshen that up. Bucky wants to flip you off right now.
Wildy and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Also sponsored by Coors Light. Weekdays 9 to noon on 94.5 ESPN. And available wherever you get your podcasts with Wisconsin On Demand.
Hey, this is Brad Nortman, here to tell you about my friends at Bank 5-9. Everywhere I go throughout the area, I see Bank 5-9, and it's no wonder why. Not only do they have 14 branch locations, but their employees spend nearly 9,000 hours each year volunteering in the communities that they serve. That's on top of the financial support that they provide to several hundred nonprofits right here in southeastern Wisconsin. If you're looking for a true local community bank, check them out today at bank59.com. Member FDIC.
Ben Brust here to tell you about the Princeton Club. I joined the Princeton Club because I was looking for a place I could invest in my health, and the environment and the community I have felt has made it so easy for me to incorporate it into my everyday life. It doesn't matter where you're at in your fitness journey, because they have something to offer everyone. It also goes beyond fitness. From the moment you walk in the club to the moment you walk out, there is a togetherness felt throughout the members and staff that keeps you going for your better tomorrow. Don't wait any longer. Get started on your fitness journey by going to PrincetonClubNewBerlin.com. That's PrincetonClubNewBerlin.com.
Stay up to date on the Green and Gold all off season. The Green and Gold Fix podcast is brought to you by Pottawatomie Casino Hotel. Luxury stay, elite play, unwind in sophisticated comfort. Win big, dine, and experience the events in Milwaukee.
Q Club of Wisconsin is the hangout spot for watching sports, playing games, and having some drinks. Mike, what do you have going on over there?
We have so much going on. We're the place to be for basketball season. With TVs everywhere, book a party in our VIP room, which includes a private pool table, two shuffleboard tables, and four dartboards. Sign up for summer bocce leagues now before they fill up. And of course, we've got our fish fry on Wednesdays and Fridays, where you know we pile it high!
All happening at the Q Club of Wisconsin, North Grandview Boulevard in Waukesha. Check out QClubOfWisconsin.com.
It's time for the Marquette Minute on 94.5 ESPN. Marquette fans, Buffalo Wild Wings is the official viewing party location for Marquette road games this season. The next watch party will be March 14th at the Oak Creek Buffalo Wild Wings for the Big East Tournament. Marquette watch parties will continue for all Big East and NCAA tournament games.
Senior night was spoiled for Tyler Kolek and Oso Iguodaro as the 8th-ranked Golden Eagles fell to number 2 UConn 74-67 at Fiserv Forum. After the game, head coach Chaka Smart gave an update on Kolek's injury status ahead of the Big East tournament next week.
I don't really want to prognosticate, you know, what the percentage chance he is to play in the Big East tournament, but he definitely is starting to feel better.
Marquette drops to 22-8 overall and 13-6 in Big East play. They wrap up regular season play Saturday afternoon at Xavier.
This has been the Marquette Minute on 94.5 ESPN. Check out the Golden Eagles watch party schedule at gomarquette.com/BWW for upcoming locations.
Hey, so have you tried fried chicken from Quick Trip? Ooh, freshly cooked, hot, and ready. And I'm talking jumbo, hand-breaded chicken tenders, boneless wings dripping with all your favorite sauces. Or how about 8 pieces of fried chicken deliciousness? Perfect for your next large group meal. I mean, this is fried chicken that slays. I mean, I'm talking about the runway. Slays appetites. Fills you up. This is no ordinary chicken. It'll make any meal extraordinary. Quick Trip fried chicken. Ready for your next meal. See you next time.
Every child deserves a safe, loving, and permanent home. Help the Dave Thomas Foundation for Adoption find families for children who've lingered in foster care the longest. Learn more at DaveThomasFoundation.org.
This is Kyle Brustin Nortman, KBN, on ESPN Wisconsin and WisconsinOnDemand.com.
I'm out and about the community. You know who else is out and about the community? Bank 5-9. My friends at Bank 5-9, I know them personally. They're the best. They can be relied on. They have a community focus. Not only do they take care of you, their client, they take care of the community. They have 14 branch locations. So listen to this. Their employees spend nearly 9,000 hours per year volunteering in the communities they serve. They give away countless sums of money to local charities and sponsorships to continue to push the community forward. They take care of you. They take care of the community. And they offer the top financial support, as well as hundreds of non-for-profits right here in southeastern Wisconsin. They literally put the community in Community Bank. What other bank do you know has a mantra of make lives better? Answer, none. Only Bank 5-9. If you're looking for a true local community bank, check them out today at bank59.com. Member FDIC.
We are Kyle Brustin Nortman. That was Brad Nortman. I'm Ben Brust alongside Kyle Walls as well.
This is one of his greatest songs ever.
Dr. Duke?
Yeah, Let's Get Loose.
Yeah, Let's Get Loose was vibing in the Bank 5-9.
Wow. I think I heard that first in about 1973 or 4.
You know, it's interesting how much joy Homer gets from like the most random of things.
No one listens to the words and music. It's the beat.
Do you remember the first time you heard it?
What?
Do you remember the first time you heard it?
Yeah, Vegetable Buddies. That's what I didn't even like.
What does that mean? First time you heard it, Vegetable Buddies.
All right, hold on. Vegetable Buddies was a bar.
Okay, I thought it had something to do with Dr. Duke and the tomato. Because the tomato is a fruit, but sometimes a vegetable.
I had never heard of it. I didn't go there to hear music. I just went there, and I'm just playing. And I go like, holy crap, this guy is so good. So I followed Duke Tomato and the All-Star Frogs for...
You followed them?
I bet I saw him 20 times.
Holy moly.
That's a lot. Do they know you? Local guy.
Oh, wow. You're famous.
We got to get you.
You're more famous than Dr. Duke. Is he still with us?
No, I believe he is. But
Let's get Dr. Duke on the show.
That'd be unbelievable.
When Peyton Manning was in Indianapolis, he used to do a song for the radio station. There's a famous station, Tom and Dave, I think. I think they were national. Anyway, he would do a song every week for him. And so,
Chris,
that's
can you
when
get Dr. Duke on Homer
that's
Hour?
When I asked him to get it to do Brett Favre as an alien.
Have you ever spoken?
Does he have a social media that could contact him that way or no?
I don't know.
He's 77. You better get him quick.
Have you ever? Yes. Have you ever spoken to him?
Like, yes.
Like
when
backstage?
I saw him, no. When I saw him in Milwaukee, he was Dr. Duke and the Power Trio, and I go, "What the hell happened to the All Star Frogs?" He goes, "They're gone 15 years ago.
Oh, wow.
Where you been?"
Well, getting away from the olds and going to the youth, the Packers are young as can be.
Let's have a parade. Are you guys you guys doing the parade?
What parade?
Shouldn't everybody be so happy? Problem with Goody is he never drafts big money free agents. He did it.
I'm
excited about it.
No, you don't get excited. The job is not done.
He's worried about a veteran.
I didn't say the job is done. But year in and year out, understandably so, why don't the Packers ever do anything?
It's funny.
Spend
they do
the
it now and he's
now.
Complaining.
Yeah,
still.
Well, forget it. You're fired as a fan. You're on probation.
No, you guys are celebrating. I'm happy that he did this,
yes.
But I want him to finish the job because he said he wants
Fine,
to compete for championships. Finish the job.
All right, but
that's what Kobe said.
He did more for the job than he has ever done before, and no one ever thought he would do it again because he doesn't do this. Now, a few years ago, he had 4 defensive players, but never at the kind of money it costs to have this guy.
3 and a swing tackle and 3 defensive players that aren't like – I guess right. Darius Smith
this
was
is
good,
biggest,
but this is a huge
yeah, signing.
Big
signing since Reggie White.
And the reason
not,
why
not
it is.
As good as
wait
Reggie
a minute.
White.
Charles
oh, yeah.
Woodson was definitely.
No,
wait,
let Homer they talk. Got Charles Woodson when nobody wanted him.
Yeah.
They didn't pay nothing for Charles. This was like the first day.
That's
I'm
true.
Sure
yeah,
all
Woodson
the other,
turned out
all the
well.
Other teams
you said this is bigger than Reggie White?
No.
Since.
In terms
big
of
since,
the
yeah.
Packers participating in the high-end free agency at the beginning, this was the closest thing to Reggie White.
Fair.
Did you have your doubts going into it that
no,
he would actually
no,
do it?
No, I had no doubts he was never going to do this.
So you thought
no
for
doubt.
Sure, no chance,
no.
And then it totally
no.
shocked you.
Yeah.
He had to make a splash with somebody.
He didn't somebody. Know he did.
He never
did.
Has to
no,
do anything.
He had to sign some. I mean, Josh Jacobs, that
no.
was something I did not expect. I didn't know if it was going to be Xavier McKinney, but he was going to have to sign one of the top safeties out
no.
there because the hole is massive
so
back
what?
There.
There.
You got
other...
rid of everybody. You had to bring in somebody
hey,
who was
so,
legit.
So real quick.
Why would they got
Adrian Amos?
Yeah.
So but real quick, last year, Kyle, the hole was just as big.
Yeah.
But you had Darnell Savage, too.
They didn't even
they
want
didn't,
Darnell
they
Savage.
They didn't
had,
want him.
But
they
just because they had him
they didn't
doesn't
have
mean
money.
It's a hole. Doesn't mean it's not a hole.
Well, and you could get
and then they signed Rudy Ford
too.
And Jonathan
Every
Owens.
Year
that
the
safety
last
year sucked.
20, they've been open to big money free agent if they wanted to do it. They didn't want to do it. That's not what he does.
Well,
that's the big question. You need to get him on.
Well,
what the hell changed? You smoking dope?
No, not smoking
you
dope.
You going with that he's, higher love stuff?
No, he's smoking love. That's what he's smoking love.
It's got to be close to him,
so
right?
He
might
has
be.
To, yeah,
might
and
be.
So he, when and we all, as human beings, we want our person, our pick, the team that we get, the tournament's coming. Everybody's going to pick a team. We're going to be cheering for that team because that's who we hitched our wagon to. He has hitched his wagon to Jordan Love. And what makes his legacy cemented in Green Bay history? If Jordan Love not only is successful but can win championships, you need to build a team around Jordan Love in
okay.
order to get to what you want to get to. And
they
that's
are.
Why he made
okay,
the decision.
The other thing, if the price to be paid for him to go big money is Aaron Jones out and Josh Jacobs in, I'll do it every day and twice on Sunday. If that's what he has to do to feel comfortable with making this other thing, it's been nice knowing
I
you.
I thought you were more loyal than that.
No, it's a business.
No,
he's just
not.
Trying to do
no,
it.
No, it's
he's
not a business. It's assessing talent. They, right or wrong, Goody thinks Josh Jacobs is way better than Aaron Jones. Not a little bit better, way better. Now, you may disagree. That's what the essence of pro football is, trying to judge talent. He was willing to pay him twice. He thinks there's nothing to do with business since you judge talent and you think this guy is way better than that guy.
When I say business, I mean the fact that he's 3 years younger. And
no.
I'm agreeing with you, Homer. I'm saying he looks at Jones. He's paying Josh Jacobs, like you said, twice as much money
right.
mm-hmm. in a $12 million guarantee basically in 1 year
yeah.
to say, hey, you are 3 years younger. I
younger.
Need you to be a guy that can produce more
way,
than Aaron Jones
way
does.
Better.
He once
Twice
paid Aaron
good.
Jones the same amount of money, fellas. Let's stop. He's Aaron Jones is just getting older, and Josh Jacobs is younger. That's all it is. It was a swap.
But an important swap.
He decides on age. But the point is,
and you're making the point for him, saying they gave it to Jones at the same age.
Josh Jacobs is way. There may be one more way better than Aaron Jones.
I disagree.
I know, but that's why he made the move that he made. You wouldn't have done it because you think Aaron Jones is closer to the same as Josh Jacobs, right?
I think he is closer to Josh Jacobs. Statistically speaking.
But you also know that you can't give Aaron Jones the ball. Tausch said it.
Right.
15 to 20 has been that sweet spot for the last five years of touches.
Also knows this. He'll never do what he did in this last season. Five games in a row, 100 yards, nothing. I'll bet you whatever you want to bet, never happened again. That was his best.
Get rid of him at his peak.
Well, if you think this other guy is that much better. Okay, let's do the yardage this year. And his stats, Jacobs between Aaron Jones.
Oh, I think Jacobs is going to crush him in stats.
Yeah.
Why? Even though Aaron Jones will likely get the ball.
Because he plays for the Minnesota Vikings. Yeah, exactly. That's why.
That is a part of it. No, but it's too bad because if you were the GM, you think of Aaron Jones as being so much better than Goody does. You'd have given him the 7. And let's go. Bring him back, right?
Rain Man, Jason Wilde.
Right.
Yeah. TVV.
We'll see who's right.
Is that what up?
Oh, no. We have
Mike Lucas.
The hardest interview I've ever done.
All right. Here we go. 2 minutes.
Dying from colon cancer. How do you interview somebody dying from colon cancer? You guys got to be any help?
We'll find out. Kyle Bruston Nortman.
I put my card in. I pump. When it clicks, I pull it out. I put it away.
Problems on 43 northbound right now. We do have what was an accident on the northbound side. The left lane is blocked right now, just around at Silver Spring, just north of Silver Spring to be exact. And it is really kind of backing things up all the way back to about Capitol Drive. So be prepared.